Right to sheets.
Because I made the entire fucking map yesterday, and it took me like 4 goddamn hours for all this stuff. And I only got like 3 hours of sleep. So we're gonna do it like this. We're gonna do it live. Fuck it.
We're doing it live.
Hang on a sec. Probably could post it in the campaign hub or media discussion. I'm posting the stream in the Lancer like Discord. Just give me a
the stream.
Sugar, I forgot to level up.
Oh, sugar. Here we go again.
I'll do it secretly. License accusation request.
What? There's a button to level up in the character sheet.
Yeah. Yes, there is.
Okay. Alright. Everybody is ready?
Nah.
Alright. Cool and good. Alright, well, so you guys kind of muster out of the cryostasis after going in for probably what would be about, in real time, it's about a week, it's a couple months, however the jump through the blink gate only feels like a couple days just because wibbly wobbly timey wimey magic. As you guys kind of begin to wake up, essentially just kind of going through the safety procedures and all that good stuff to make sure you guys don't have cryosickness. You hear over the radio or over the comms. Good morning, Team 2. How is everyone doing? Please report to the main deck at right fucking now. And then you just hear a hard click as Dom kind of calls you and then leaves you to your business to kind of muster and begin the day. What would you like to do?
I will get my ass where the captain told me to get my ass.
Hey, might as well get moving in it.
Yeah.
Blah, blah.
Just woke up from cryo sleep, man. So tired.
I want to die.
Don't we all?
Nah.
I'm just the angle.
It's too mainstream.
Aiden, what are you up to?
I also forgot Captain.
Okay. Alright, so as you guys
do your charge, remember.
As you guys make your way towards the main bridge, you all kind of get suited up in your regular gear and kind of make your way to a command room. It's kind of it's your basic layout. You have a giant kind of large projector table in the middle of the room with some chairs and just kind of different mechanics, engineers, and pilots going about doing different tasks with the whirls and beeps and boops of basically a very lively command deck. On the main kind of, I guess, the center of the projector screen, you see what appears to be kind of like a bright, almost transparent firecracker that's it has a really long fuse, but the fuse seems to be lit, and it's not actually burning or anything. It's just kind of sparking, if that makes sense. And it's kind of slowly rotating around the center of the table, kind of just giving you a full view of this firecracker that's always lit. You can see Dom just kind of leaning over the table with another another person he's just kind of filling in and kind of talking to while the rest of you pull in. And let me pull up the compium real quick. There we go. Okay. And he kind of notices you're all there, and he kind of beckons you in and goes, how you guys doing? I want you to meet Hector Viscara. He's going to be joining you for today's mission. He's a new guy, but team lead. I want you to kind of take him under your wings and make sure he doesn't get shot. This one was a little expensive. And he kind of just pushes Hector towards you guys and says, I'll give you guys a couple minutes just to kind of meet and greet, then come to me when you guys are ready to get briefed on the mission.
All right. I mean,
Desmond will walk over to be prepared for the mission. To breathe.
I mimic the new guy.
Ah, yes, our team leader is now also the new guy. Oh no.
Host?
Well, Jesus Christ, don't all talk at once. Say something, you fucking quiet people.
Desmond.
You guys, say your name. Tell us an interesting fact about yourself. Jesus Christ, you guys, didn't you fight in wars or something? What do I pay you people for?
You don't pay
to a certain extent, the caught in wars, it taught us not to introduce ourselves, because then you start caring about people, and then they die, and then it's a whole
Do I pay
time.
You?
Sometimes.
Stand in front of the class and say your name.
Hector Viscar, background Farfield team.
I mimic what he says.
Call sign Locksmith.
Oh, Jesus. Rest of you children, stand up and say your name. Introduce yourself to Locksmith.
He said that would stand up and look at the team leader and go, he's a liar. And then sit back down.
What? Okay.
Bloody hell.
Uncalled for?
She actually points to the reel.
Well, if we're gonna be working together, I'm Marcus. Over there, we got current team lead who... well, just likes to copy people because he's un-fucking original.
He's a liar.
A professional liar.
So you weren't just referring to me when you called me a liar.
No, I said...
I mean, I'm pretty sure he might be able to devise that himself from seeing a second of himself.
Yeah, I literally just watched him turn into me.
Merlin, sound off. Echo, you too.
Oh yeah, Ghost, I'm studying.
Dog, Saber, fucking introduce yourselves to fucking
new guy. Okay,
Jesus Christ.
Gosh.
Ghost?
What?
I'm watching Dom's movements. I'm studying him.
Wonderful. I feel like we have a spiritual connection already. Merlin, your turn.
I'm Gustavus Adolphus, call sign Merlin. I'm the doc. I'll patch you up, and yep.
Wonderful. Don't we just feel all cheery and wonderful like a team already? Team lead, come on over. Stand up in front of the class.
Everyone's going back to bed.
I do.
All right. Now, does anyone have any questions before we get started? Y'all remember what I told you before you went into cryosleep?
No.
Alright, lovely.
Do some jobs with some big wigs for about fire, yeah.
Alright, well, Katie here is going to introduce the mission, and in case you have any questions, please direct them to her. I kind of more just handle the more logistics side of this, and Dom actually begins to kind of step away here as the what was originally the spinning firecracker set actually begins to kind of rotate a little bit faster and faster until it becomes a semi-translucent person. It's Katie's an AI. And Katie kind of brings herself down onto the table and kind
if
of...
You don't use a female voice, I'm going to be angry.
I'm not going to, but...
just, you know...
Just send the script to Des. Problem solved.
So she begins. She does the spin, and she starts to kind of look around at each and every one of you, and just kind of nod to herself as if she's kind of making. She's just assessing each of you based off of what she has. Now, Katie is a second generation AI, meaning there is a total known of 4 generations. Each generation is in relation to the level of artificial humanity. Every AI is incredibly intelligent, but the level with which they can operate dictates what generation they are. So for example, Katie being a second generation AI, she follows the 3 principles of robotics to a T. She cannot break them, she cannot fold against them. A first generation AI is essentially just an extremely smart calculator compared to her, but it was one of the original AIs to help launch the Union through the first and beginning stages of the second. Then second generation, third, continued. Third generation AI are a lot more like, think of them as kind of planet-wide administration. They can kind of interact and handle just about anything on a planet scale. However, they are still deeply ingrained in follow true to the 3 principles of robotics, being obviously cannot harm humans, you know, must hold, protect life at all costs, and then follow the mission, that kind of stuff, okay? So, after Katie kind of takes a couple seconds to just kind of look around at each and every one of you, she kind of comes back to the team lead and goes, "Hi, I'm Katie, how are you?"
I mimic Katie and I say the same thing.
Don't listen, he's a lie.
Katie looks over at Des and just goes, "He's funny."
Hell yeah.
So,
is our team leader just a robot also, or what's going on?
Aiden essentially mimics Katie, so he is now a semi-translucent, bright orange female, essentially standing with all of you. So Katie begins to kind of explain, as Dom had on the end of the first mission, with you guys will be going down, or you guys are going to be going down to check a planet of completely rich of Algorium for one of the Union's kind of refinery-approved subsidy corporations. Does anyone remember what Algorium is?
Something about hyperfuel and makes ships go.
Yes, so essentially, Algorium is not exactly a fuel as much as it is an extremely valuable conductor of energy. So when a ship goes through a blink gate, the hyperfuel actually is the kind of stabilizer to make sure the ship doesn't get blasted into pieces when it goes faster than light. It's able to sustain the ship and keep the shields raised for the duration of the entire voyage through the blink gate, as if the shields were to falter, the ship would very likely have a massive EMP surge and completely destroy the ship. So it's really important that this subsidy corporation is able to efficiently, cleanly, and legally mine and distribute all of the algorithm that we can process. Now, of course, the reason that you guys will be tasked out for this mission today is there's a concern of illegal mining on the planet Gamma. And she holds up she kind of raises her hand, and you see a giant, almost dusty world that is just kind of slowly rotating. And here, I will bring it up on the game. What?
Sorry to interrupt, but I just found out how to enter combat as, like, while you're in the actual, like, pilot thing. There's an actual way to enter.
Yeah.
In CompCon. I didn't realize.
I just noticed also.
Yeah, like, I accidentally fucking found it.
I was like, hey, what's this? Oh!
Squares.
Yeah.
And lots of diamonds.
Yeah, where'd the hexes go?
Yeah, you're not in combat, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, this is just a world map. Also, is this Mars?
Are we in Mars? Are we on Mars?
No, you're on Gamma. It's a very dusty planet.
Ah, yes. Ah, yes. Okay, I know what you're saying. Mars ripoff.
Yeah, this is
pretty far from the original solar
planet Mars.
No, it's Gamma. It's the Gamma. It's Planet Gamma in the Extraditious
Ganymede
system.
Finish leveling up.
Yay!
Katie continues on after the quick discussion, saying, after some initial scans, we were able to identify. Let me see if I can. There we go. Identifying three areas of concern. And she begins to slowly kind of. You see three areas light up.
I'll mark it down on your minimap.
Three areas light up as.
Side quests.
As areas that have been reported to identify local or illegal mining activities, she then sends a file to the team lead saying, team lead, you're going to need this. And it's the official documentation of the subsidied or refinery corporation under the union to remove any and all illegal, or it's essentially a cease and desist for all mining activities on the Gamma planet. And Dom kind of interjects now and says, you know, we're, our job is to try and peacefully remove these people, but, well, I'm going to be sending you in armed just in case. Don't try and shoot up the whole damn place, but if you can, you know, try and get them to leave peacefully, because I want all these done in today. I don't want to have to come back. So with that, he's essentially saying any damage you take throughout any of these areas will carry over into the next. You will not be able to heal unless you have the means to do so.
So.
There any questions so far?
Yeah, do we have a time limit before we need to leave?
You have 5 solar days starting here. It's the 12th of 27. You'll need to you'll need to clear this out within about 5 solar days.
How long is a solar day?
1 hour.
What?
Damn.
So we have 5 hours to do this.
Damn.
What's the travel time between the 3 locations?
It's
1 hour.
1 hour.
Fuck.
So
make it snappy.
Crab rave.
1 hour for each location.
Yep.
Okay.
2 hours. Easy.
Now, there's of course the monetary discussion that needs to be brought up. The contract has been won by the Black Star Mercenary Group for 1,000,000 mana. Now, team lead, it's going to be your job to divvy it up amongst your crew. I don't care who or how much you pay each of them. That's not my business, and that's how we run such a tight ship here. It's how we keep a small private listings instead of a large corporation. It's a very very savvy business, if I do say so myself. And if there's any questions in regards to if you wish to hire out either myself or the 2 other Lancers and or additional gear, now is the time to... Let's talk about that.
Oh, that's a good point, yeah. They did say that we can hire some extra people for free because, you know, other team was going to pay for it.
Well, if there's no healing, it would be nice to get some extra healing gear.
Healing gear?
Healing.
I mean, there's no guarantee we even be in combat.
Yeah, if we do everything right, we shouldn't need to enter combat.
Yeah, but if we do...
We can also bring extra people with us, remember, so, you know.
But do we have to pay them?
The squad of grunts.
Bring some red shirts.
Team lead, what are we doing?
Let's do...
Okay. Well, you have the squad that Team 1 is going to be providing for you guys, so that's an armament of basically 6 grunts. Do you need anything else?
Just any extra gear that the rest of the team requests.
I'm asking you, what do they need?
What do you guys need?
Medical supplies.
I mean, I've got a corrective on me just in case we get a DBNO.
We need medical supplies.
Ammo. Water.
I'm gonna assume the planet at least has a breathable atmosphere.
It's enough, but I would definitely recommend you wear your hard suits just to be safe.
Oxygen. I mean,
why would we not wear our hard suits?
Adequate survivability equipment.
Okay, yeah. So let me start off with this. There's three different things that we can equip you out with. Of course, there is the added cloning facilities, which if you wish to approve for now, we can sign that on for your total bonuses for each of you.
True.
Did it last time.
Yeah, I'm just making sure that you all remember, since apparently you don't even remember the mission I told you before you went into cryo.
I don't know what you're talking about. Remember perfectly, thank you very much.
Alright, yeah.
You had to work to...
Oh, now suddenly everyone's memory works. Interesting how that works.
Well, I just wanted to make sure.
That's all right. So yes,
we have one question.
What?
There are a bunch of diamonds on the map. What do those diamonds represent?
Those are the different Algorium veins. Those are what the corporate state has identified as potential areas that we will need to check out. However, Katie has already gone ahead and scanned the planet for you and identified these three areas. He then points to the map. Green being what appears to be a very small outpost. There's only a few buildings. The yellow one, he points to the one in the middle of the map. We already do have confirmation that there are quite a few people moving around in this facility. And then the red one, he points to, is essentially a small village.
The placement of green suggests a heretofore unknown vein. Comparative to the yellow and red.
Your job isn't to worry about the veins, son. Your job is to get these people off this planet.
That's fair.
Remember, just like with the training simulation we did last time, your job isn't just to go in and kill everything. Your job is to do the objective, finish the mission, and get paid so I can go back to smoking my cigars.
At least he's a man of taste.
Now, we have the cloning settled. I can give you some medical supplies. One person can carry an item with them that will fully restore the health of one of the team members. It has two charges, but it will take an item slot. That's going to cost you a 5% of your total contract. Is that all right?
I'll take it.
Excuse me, 3%, sorry. So one person's will be carrying it. However, it will take one of your two item slots.
Wait, what is that called? Two item slots?
No, we have three.
One, sorry.
We have three. Yeah.
Oh, three. We have three.
Yeah.
Okay, so
it
takes
here.
One. Regardless, yeah. It takes one.
Mod, I don't want to replace one of my own pieces again, though.
Yeah.
I would do it.
I don't care who does it. Team lead, you decide. Now, there's also the possibility of anything else bigger and uglier than you showing up, and I'll be honest, again, you don't have mechs yet, and if something bigger and uglier shows up, you might want to be prepared. That ain't a warning, that's very likely a promise. These guys, from the looks of it, they've been here for a while, and they don't think they're going to want to leave too easy.
A couple of EMP.
Does it see EMPs?
Yeah.
All right. Again, that'll just take
actual grenades.
Take actual grenades, yeah.
You have your actual grenades on there, so
I want more.
Well, you're limited by the confines of the game.
You are limited by the confines of reality, Batman. Right.
So,
Saber, you'll be carrying the.
What's the thing called? Yes.
It was you who asked to carry it, right?
Yes. Yeah. What was the name of the thing?
What was the name of the thing?
It's just a medical kit.
It was a medical kit.
And it heals all health?
It'll full heal you. There's two charges, though.
The charges. All right, cool.
This is just a better. Yeah, okay. All
right. Dog, you being the sniper, you'll be keeping at a range. Kaiser, what I want you to do.
Yeah, I have a sniper for my mech. There's no sniper for pilot weapons.
Yeah.
We'll just have a heavy special then. That's got range 10. That's close enough.
Yeah. I guess I'm.
Slash bone brew it. Just add plus 3 tiles to your heavy weapon gun.
Yeah, I'm just using a heavy sig.
Yeah, we'll just quote unquote that it's a sniper rifle.
Yeah.
Kaiser, what I want you to do is if you find that your armor is still impenetrable, I want you to start dragging people out from cover and throwing them into the fire of Dog. Hopefully, his sniper fire can hit them. Everyone else, I want you to in cover and constant fire to suppress the enemy. I will be going in stealth and will only come out when shit gets fucked. In other words, I'll be taking people out quietly. So shit actually gets done. Does everyone agree on this?
Well, see if diplomacy works first.
Constantly suppressing fire.
So that's their combat strategy. Now, what do we have as choices, before we go fighting everything?
What? Sorry?
We can convince them to leave quietly. That is our best option.
Yeah.
Okay, updated my pilot data for you guys, if you want to load it.
We don't even know if there is any cover.
There's bound to be cover. If there isn't, then duck and roll. If there isn't, duck and roll. That's all I can say.
So shouldn't we just be trying our best not to go into combat?
Yes, that is the objective, but we're getting ready for combat.
I agree, Taser, late thing.
Sound like a World War II siren.
That's my sister.
Vacuum?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wouldn't the best way of avoiding combat is not shoving our guns in their face?
I don't know how else to say this. We're going to be trying to avoid combat, so we're not going to act hostile towards them. If anyone does, you will get shot.
Well, that's not, also that's be not shot at, if that works.
So shouldn't we, not bring our guns?
We're going to bring the guns, because they're going to have their guns. Because we don't want to get shot, so we're going to bring our guns.
Katie pipes in.
Our objective is not to harm humans.
Katie pipes in and adds to the discussion. By the way, TL, you know that you have, and then again she brings up the documents, just to avoid any confrontation.
It's no guarantee. But to be safe, team lead probably shouldn't do the talking.
Yeah. I agree.
Why? I've been doing fine until now until you all complained
bullshit.
About bull fucking shit. We're going. Go.
Are you guys ready?
Yep.
Which one do you want to do first?
TO, which one are you striking first?
We're doing green first. We'll do
green first. Sounds good.
Crabbers.
Go ahead and get into Shuttle Pod 3. The pilot, the dropship will fly you on down there. Go ahead and just signal for them whenever you are ready for pickup and drop off, and they'll be kind of your chauffeur around. I'll be jumping to another system. I want to drop off Team 1 at another location to continue. I'll see you on the other side. Good luck, pilots. And he dismisses you to go about. Is there anything anyone wants to do before they go and begin the mission?
Yeah. I'd like to make sure I get backed up in the cloning bay first, since I don't think I did that before going into cryosleep.
Okay.
I do have one question.
Yep.
What was the AI's name again?
Katie.
Mm-hmm. Can you download all of the relevant data and documents to my data plating?
Sure, can do.
Wait, so Katie's gonna is an AI? Question mark?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Katie is a second generation AI.
Katie, do you have any music?
Yes, of course. I can send that to your personal room.
No.
Where would you like the music, Pilot?
I would like the music to follow me.
That would require an additional AI.
I have a drone.
Like,
oh, you're gonna have a boombox drone?
Oh no, no matter what, this is trying to beat the fucking boombox.
He kind of looks off for a second, and you see the drone kind of perk up as she begins to essentially transfer the top 20 space hottest music onto the drone.
Thank
That's
you.
Glorious. Yes. Do you have a scouting drone? Is that what that is?
I think it's just a generic drone, isn't it?
Yeah, it doesn't really.
The drone is meant for scouting, though, so we're gonna use that as a scouting drone.
Your drone now has the ability to. It has a small speaker, so it's not gonna give you the most stellar audio, but.
Listen, it's doing its best.
It's able. It is now able to remotely play music.
Yes.
So yes, Kaiser, we'll go ahead and send you to the cloning facilities. Does anyone else wish to go and get backed up before they go? You have essentially already signed to pay for it.
Yeah, I will as well.
Okay. Bye, Knuckle. All
right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so all six of you, and let me just write that down. I gotta remember what I'm charging all of you.
But should I though?
Do you have the sound system gear thing?
Sound system gear thing? What?
Yeah, in the pilot gear, there's a one called sound system.
Is there?
Yeah.
I thought there was one in the Mac.
The ability to play music.
There's one in the Mac.
Yeah, I don't know why you didn't take that with us. You could have been the fucking boombox from the get-go.
No, there is one for the pilots, too.
Yeah, it's called sound system.
Anywho, stop arguing about boomboxes. I'm already hungover for this, and I don't care. Dom kind of directs you towards the cloning facilities, so you go out into the main, kind of the main hall of the entire ship, and it's literally, the left is the drop ships / the cryobeds, and then the right is the cloning facilities and kind of soul storage. And they call it the soul storage, and this desk kind of alludes back to your question as to why you can't kind of just take a spit swab of a dead body and then just kind of reanimate
them. No, that's not answering my question. Science.
So as you kind of mosey into the cloning facilities, it's a pretty moderately sized room for essentially being on a spaceship. I mean, as you know, many ships are extremely space conscious. So, you know, you might have bunk beds inside the living quarters, or the gym room is also, you know, essentially doubles as an armory. The cloning facility is an entire room that is dedicated to exclusively the retention and holding of clones, and then the data that the system uplink will use to essentially as accurately as possible mimic the actions and thoughts of the original pilot. So all this means is when the doctor kind of comes over and shakes your hands and he goes, "Oh, hi, how you doing? My name is James Thomerson. How are you doing today?"
Good.
He looks at each and every one of you kind of quickly.
Doing just fine, Doc.
Is there a phone I can use?
Yes, it's on the wall. And he kind of quickly looks back at Kaiser. Are you the team lead?
No, but I might as well be.
Wonderful. Okay, so if you will, each and every one of you, just go ahead and take a seat right over here. And he kind of gestures towards about five or six different seats. Each has a, it almost looks like more of like a surgical table. It's not exactly a couch or a chair. It's got some padding, but you notice that there is very three distinct, very sharp-looking needles kind of right at the base of the armchair. And he says, "Go ahead and just take a seat right there, please."
Des would walk over to the phone booth and try to call home.
Yeah, I'll sit by the table thing.
Me too.
All right.
And he kind of comes over. Now, which one of you is the TL?
Me.
It Anonymous is, yeah.
Grit Jensen.
Jinxit. Nice to meet you, Grit. My name is Jameis Defferson, and what we're going to be doing here is a little procedure called synthetic mapping. Now, what's going to happen is this little doohickey on the back of the chair here is going to surgically insert itself into the base of your neck and begin essentially mapping out your entire brain system. So essentially what will happen is when the computer, you see, wants to essentially mimic the soul as close as we can get, because we still can't do that just yet, we're going to essentially insert you, the pilot, into another world of your choosing. And I highly recommend that you keep the code that you will see inside your dream as close to you as possible, because if anyone else gets that, they can pretty much mimic you to a T. He then kind of walks over towards, you see, like three or four very kind of clear filled solutions with five or six just kind of bodies floating inside these tubes, all in the fetal position, just kind of listing there. Some of them, it's kind of a mixed match, honestly, between both men and women. The tubes really don't discern nor care. There's just, it's just three tubes full of people. And he kind of gently kind of pats the tubes and goes, "This right here is our real moneymaker. It holds all the clones until you need them or you die." And he kind of quickly, frantically walks back over to you, Grit, and it goes, "So once the system has mapped out your brains, it'll then, if you die, of course, I really hope you don't do that, because it's incredibly expensive to grow these bad boys." He points back at the cloning machine and goes, "We'll then upload it to one of these clone dummies. And once the dummy is fully mapped out to your system, well, it's pretty much you. And better hope there aren't two of you, because we'll have to kill one of you." And with that, he says, "Is there any questions for me today?"
"Hello, Mom."
Dad, you just hear the idle ringtone of a beep, 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 beep as the ship was unable to connect.
Oof.
Big rip.
Young lady, if you're trying to reach anybody outside of this ship, I highly recommend you do it on one of the planets, as this ship, that phone is only able to connect and communicate to anyone on this ship here.
Vessel.
Thank you, TL.
She would hang up the phone, but I can't clone myself.
What?
She'd walk away.
Okay. Who is she?
I think he's
kid of the group, apparently.
Young ones, yes. They're always very uncomfortable with the whole, you know, we'll make a complete perfect identical replica of you. It's, they'll get used to it. Usually after the first cloning batch and we kill off a clone or two, you kind of lose it a little bit. Anywho, so go ahead and just hold on to these armchairs here. They're nice and cushy. Would anyone like some water? I know usually the first couple times you get a really weird bitter taste. Would anyone like some water before we begin?
Water.
All right, perfect. He immediately slams a button on the wall, and each of you feel a very sharp but then immediately fading sensation as the three-pronged needles basically push themselves into your spinal column. And each of you, you don't black out per se, but you go into another area, another kind of plane, if you will, as the ship begins to essentially create what each of you would describe as your happy place. So this is something that you guys can do either right now or, you know, whenever you get some inspiration. I'll need each of you to send me four numbers. And a brief description of what each of your characters' happy place looks like, as the ship is essentially trying to create and understand your brain patterns for the cloning process. Okay?
Well, okay.
So this whole ordeal takes between 4 to 5 hours, depending on how frequently you've done it. Since each of you hasn't actually, you know, this isn't the first time that you've been, copied, if you will, or recorded. The process only takes about 4.5 hours, four-ish hours, and you kind of, as you're in your place of happiness, you begin to hear a very faint and just kind of droning noise as the area that you are begins to slowly grow increasingly red. As it's essentially the ship is trying to let you know we're about to pull you out of your location, you know, try not to freak out too much as you go from one place of existence back to your bodies. And I want each of you to roll a 1d20 for essentially a constitution check.
Yeah.
Oh boy.
So are we doing like a fucking...
No, you're essentially rolling a cloning sickness. Or a cloning synapse sickness.
So a skill check.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, essentially.
Can I add a stay cool plus 2 to turn my 2 into a 4?
No, because this is literally just a neural uplink from your brainstem getting ripped very quickly.
Can I have plus 2 to survive so I don't feel like trash?
I think we're all fucked.
Is that everybody? 1, 2, 3, 4. Taren, where are you?
And us.
I have not signed up for the cloning program at this time.
Oh, okay. So, no, then that's okay. So, Saber, as you feel the three-pronged needles get removed from your back, you shiver. You feel like your entire almost being was just forced pushed back inside you after coming out of what was essentially the happiest place you could ever imagine. And you wake up and everything just seems a little grayer and darker. The place you were at was so vibrant and colorful. You just wake up and you go, it's not the same. I want to go back. It's just not, everything just doesn't look right. Dog, as you get Jack pulled out of the system, you just feel like something isn't sitting right in your body, and the doctor kind of unstraps all of you as he was essentially just kind of watching the clones float around in the tubes, and begins to kind of unset you, and I want you to roll another constitution check. Aiden, you've done this before. You've, after many many clone copies, you know, it's, you actually already have a, you've got the scars, and your body's more or less used to kind of getting jacked in and out. So it's really not that big of a deal. You stand up and you're good to go. Kaiser, it's been a while. The scars have already started to form from the implants, and I want you and Dog to both roll a constitution check.
So fucking what? A
just 1D? Another 1d20.
Okay.
Woo.
Dog, everything that you just ate after cryo sleep is now on the floor, and
fucking
the doctor, he's not too surprised. He's a little bit disappointed. He goes, you know, here I go, gotta go again. And you, he claps, and a couple droids come out to start basically Roombaing all of the vomit that you just kind of spilled out onto his perfectly clean and sterile lab floors.
Thank you,
Kaiser. You start to feel it anymore. You start to feel it, but your combat training, you know, it teaches you to swallow and hold it in and not try and panic too much, so you don't vomitus.
Woo.
So.
Saber almost died.
Saber's in a mood. But all right. So, four of the six of you are now essentially backed up inside the system. Meaning, if you were to die on this mission, you would be back at your current level. For the two of you that do not have the cloning procedure taken care of, if you do die, you will need to create an entire new character sheet. As your character is clean dead, and the Black Star has no way of basically bringing you back.
I need my parents' permission.
Understandable. All right, with that, what do you guys want to do?
Team lead.
Go.
All right. Rally the troops and get them onto the dropship.
Let's go.
Okay.
We're heading to the dropship.
All right. So all of you kind of pile into the dropship. as you get in, you see a bunch of lightly armored men and women kind of piling with you. A more burlier gentleman. Excuse me. A more burly gentleman kind of walks over to you, Grit, and reaches out his hand and goes, "How you doing? I'm Bill Davison. I'll be the squad lead supporting you guys today. How are you?"
"Good, thank you."
"Oh, a bit sore."
I'll be working with your pilot team. Me and my boys here are going to be running some cover. If you need us to throw, we usually carry 1 AT round or anti mech round. We got a couple frag grenades amongst us and a stun grenade or two in case anything happens. Let me know," and he kind of gestures Grit, "and we'll try and make it happen."
"Okay."
So, the way that I'm going to be all NPC kind of actions, unless there is a cascade or anything that's, you know, catastrophically happens, the team lead will be more or less controlling the NPCs.
Makes sense.
Okay.
All right.
With that, you hear off in the radios, "This is your captain speaking to the wind. Wind is 14 miles to the south, starboard wind. It's a bit chilly, so I hope you all brought an extra jacket in too. And we will be departing here within the next 5 to 10 minutes. So if you see everything floating, we're on our way." And with that, Bill heads off and kind of gets his team strapped in. You guys are kind of on one half of the dropship. There's probably about enough space for 15, 20 people. And his team is kind of on the other side. And they're kind of just eyeing you guys up. I mean, the grunts are used to seeing pilots, but they don't really ever get this close to you guys. One of the random soldiers kind of looks over and goes, "So how'd you do it? How'd you guys become those Lancers, those pilots?"
"Luck.
I signed up for a job at the end of the universe and they gave me the Lancer. Part of how the job went, yes."
"Oh, that's really cool. I mean, like, I've always just wanted to be one, but, you know," and he kind of, like, looks down and you see he's a fit guy, but he's a little on the smaller side. I've been trying to work out, but what's your regimen? How do you guys prepare for that life?"
Does look down at herself and then back up at and a small more.
I'm mimic fat boy.
Why you bully him? What'd he do to you?
The rest of the squad notices that Aiden's turned into one of their guys and just kind of starts laughing and just kind of teasing them.
Well, clearly he got in through identity fraud.
The rest of the grunts kind of just chuckle and give the rando a bit of a hard time about basically getting his identity stolen right in front of him.
I pat him on the back and I say, "You'll get there."
Pat him on the back. Yeah. You're strapped into your seats.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Just give him a thumbs up. Yeah.
I give him a thumbs up. Yeah, that's fine.
Fair enough. He kind of sheepishly looks at you and returns the thumbs up, a bit worried that he needs to go change a couple passwords on his bank accounts. As the thumbs up is exchanged, there's a very noticeable rattling as the dropship begins to enter the lower atmosphere of the planet. And let me hang on. Let me pull it up here. See if this will work. Give me a quick second here. I'm trying to give you guys an icon. Soup's up.
Yes, chef.
All right, so as you guys kind of begin to planet fall, the pilot kind of gives you an update and says, all right, kids, well, we're going to be landing here shortly. And as you... Okay. Yeah, that'll do. All right. As you do, you see on your map a... Did it do it? Ah, shit, hang on. Okay. As you do, you see an icon blink into existence around the map that Dom has provided to the pilot to help him kind of locate the area, and you see a shuttle marker land next to the green settlement. With that, we will move on to the first area.
Oh, hey, it's that fucking... thing from StarCraft. I see you. Fucking Hammerhead. What the fuck was called that big transport? Hercules, that's it. There we go.
That's the one.
All right. I know you.
Oh, just wait. Alright, so. With that. Cancel. Hang on. And with that, he kind of sets you down outside the main area of. Hang on, let me pull it up again. Are you guys on this area? No, you're not, so let's pull you over to here. He sets you down kind of on the outside area of the village, or the village, excuse me. It's an outpost. It is more or less an outpost, and as you can see, deeper in...
nice. Can we get some StarCraft music?
So as you guys land on the outskirts of this outpost, you can see what appears to be an extremely large structure, what appears to be almost to be the kind of main facility. This is the main processing location for the Algorium, which you do see further inside the village. There is what appears to be an Algorium mining and refinery station that has been constructed adjacent to a spaceport. Now, what would you guys like to do?
Well, first we need to unload from the dropship.
Well, this is more of the... I'm trying to kind of get us more accustomed to the Lancer.
I'm going invisible in it.
To my understanding, pilot combat / interactions is more handled on an RP side instead of an actual, like, roll your dice and shoot them up kind of thing. So, I'll set your characters out. However, you guys aren't in combat, okay?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm going invisible and hidden.
Going invisible? Okay.
Yeah. Kaiser?
Why? That would be such a bad idea. If you get caught, they're gonna get angry.
I don't make a bot play StarCraft music.
hang on, man.
Who am I missing? I'm missing Aiden and Keanu Reeves.
With your naturally domineering personality, I want you to be taking the front on this.
What?
Just talk to them.
Okay. All right, let me guys give you control over these guys real quick. Save. Dog. Dog, save. Kaiser. Kaiser, save. Death. Save. Aiden, I'll go ahead and mark you as invisible. So we're going to use the blue icon as invisible, but then the ninja icon as hidden and stealth. Okay. Yep. So that's the full action.
Yep.
Alright. And Terran. Okay.
Okay.
I still can't control my
Oh, sorry. Because maybe I just gave you the ninja icon without actually identifying it. Alright, so Aiden, there we go. Okay, each of you has your markers. I will go ahead and I'm going to just give you a... There we go. So this squad icon is just all six of the grunts. Actually, I'll do... So I'll split them up into two teams of three. So there's a total of six of them, but each one has, quote-unquote, three people inside it. And off you go.
There we go.
One of the kind of, you see him as a guard, begins to at least come towards the outskirts of their outpost, but he doesn't approach, they don't approach any further.
Kaiser?
You are given lead on this.
I'm having to do so many things! Calm your tits!
If you guys could, put in your total health as red, your armor count as blue. Or as green, excuse me.
Which just armor? Your... Oh, armor.
Yeah, armor.
So armor is which color?
Blue? Green.
And do we put something else? Or?
Sorry?
So red health, green armor.
Uh-huh.
And
redistribute this.
What about blue? Using next.
Blue is, it's just
do you want to do now. E-defense for that then?
No, just leave it as empty for now. I just want to have it so that way I'm aware of each of your stats, because forgetful.
Cool. You know what, I just realized. Aiden, you've told me to be the lead for this, but I don't have the document, dickhead! You do!
Give me the document.
You're invisible, it'll take you out of stealth.
You're not standing next to it.
Hmm?
I hide behind Kaiser while I do it.
Fuck's sake.
Big ship. Did the ship leave already, or?
No, the ship is parked. It's essentially your convoy ship.
Hey, just go back to the ship, do the thing, and then go back out.
Wait, do you want our evasion number?
No, just armor.
So armor of your suit, hard suit, right?
Right.
Correct. Okay.
Team lead sure is taking the lead, eh?
Are all of the visible characters guards?
The ones you can see. There's a couple what appear to be kind of smaller automated mechs being controlled by people. But they're just going in between the Algorium refinery and the kind of central refinery structure.
SCV, right?
SCV!
All right.
They're not SCVs because that's copyright, and I don't want to get pulled by Blizzard.
Oh yeah, these aren't Marines ever.
They're not.
Yeah.
They are space outfitted. They're space soldiers.
You don't want to get a copyright strike, but you're using.
All right, lads.
Assets. Okay.
We're here under legal work. Let's just go up. Tell them to boot. Tell them to leave. Head on out to the next camp, alright? Simple as.
Okay.
Well, just start approaching them.
Okay. When you get about halfway, the guard kind of holds up his hand and goes,
alright, that's enough now. What y'all doing here?
Oh boy.
Ah, we see it.
It's rednecks, fuck!
What are y'all doing? State your name and business.
We're in the backwaters of the station now.
I'm Marcus. I'm here on official business, said as well. We're actually...
Cletus, what you want?
We're here to tell you that you need to...
No, don't say that.
Huh?
Here to serve a cease and desist letter.
Who's
that? Hey, Marcus, who's that fella over there? He speak for you?
Hey, we're all working together, so it's not like it really matters.
It ain't gonna be a problem. I don't want no trouble, mister.
Well, we don't want to really cause any trouble either. We're just barely doing our job, you know.
Well, what are you here for?
To serve a letter.
We're doing some work for a corporation and require you to leave the planet.
Well, hell, you sound like you guys could use a job. We need some extra arms around here. What you want? Come on, I ain't got all day. Got some boys working.
Look, you're illegally mining. I need you to pack it up and leave.
Hey, what is that? You lying, boy. First you come onto this planet, you calling me a liar now?
Look, no.
Not calling you a liar. Just want to be told.
Well, you ain't calling me the truth or neither now, ain't you?
What corporation y'all work for?
Oh, we work for Mr. Jefferson.
Mr. Jefferson doesn't have the rights to this area.
Where's your documentation?
Yes, we'll show documentation.
You could speak to Mr. Jefferson, probably.
Yeah, it's right here. I'm gonna pull it out.
Come on, closer. I ain't got fucking 5 mile looking eyes. Shit, this dude ain't got glasses on it.
We wish to show Mr. Jefferson.
What was this? And he kind of pulls out, like, you see him shuffle around inside the suit as he's almost kind of like, his hands begins to like rattle a little bit as he kind of pulls his elbow up as if he's like pulling his arm out of the suit, and then he kind of brings it back down into his pocket. And you see him actually pull out some reading glasses from inside the suit. As he's doing this, so he does get a little bit closer. And
fucking great marine suit.
A couple more guys come out of the command center and the refinery center. And...
Wait a second. You train them in barracks, not the fucking Vespine. Hey,
it's copyright.
Sorry, Algorian refinery.
So a couple of the guards kind of just crowd around you guys as the one lead, Cletus, begins to kind of just read over the document. And
we're just doing our job.
Mm-hmm. He just kind of looks at you and goes, well, young lady, looks like you got some documentation here. I ain't one to really kick up no fuss, so I'm going to suggest you go over to Jeeves on the other place. He's much better with this whole documentation thing. We're just out here mining. We don't want to trouble none of y'all.
Understood. Just pointing us in the right direction.
And with that, he kind of... Y'all got one of them maps? Hang on. Hey, John, yeah, bring out one of the maps. And you see one of the Marines kind of out over here just kind of like walk into the refinery center and just disappear for a couple seconds while he supposedly goes and gets the map for you.
Excuse me, dude.
That supposedly makes me nervous.
Right back.
You wait a couple seconds and it's kind of just empty air because you don't, you know. So, who are you guys working for?
What was the name of the...
Cletus.
I refer to the documentation for who we're working for. Who are we working for? What was their name again?
You're working for
the company we're working for is Black Star, but they got a contract for, who is it again?
You're working for Steel Lance Refinery.
Steel Lance Refinery, there you go.
Yeah, Steel Lance Refinery.
And it's called the Black Star?
The group you work...
The mercenary group
you are working with is called the Black Star Mercenary Group. The company that contracted you out is the Steel Lance Refinery Corporation. After a couple more minutes of just kind of awkward stance, Jeeves comes out with what appears to be a legitimate piece of paper. And
wow.
Brings it over to you guys and goes, well, here, I got the map here, and it's pretty much exactly like yours, except somehow they don't have nearly as many Algorium deposits marked. They just have a bunch of X's where you would see the refineries, and then you see the two the two outposts that you've already scanned on the surface and goes, "Now, you're going to want to go to this one." And he points to the middle map. "We are here," and he points to the one that you guys are currently at. "And you can find ah, hell, what's his name?
You said Jeeves earlier.
Jeeves, yeah, thank you, yeah, thank you, Jeeves. Yeah, Jeeves is the boy you're gonna want to go talk to." And he hands Des, or yeah, he hands you the map and goes, "Hold on to that, young lady."
I would nod my head graciously, thank you.
And
Clint, you're saying we need to ask Jeeves.
Yeah. Go and ask Jeeves. He can read all this legal mumbo jumbo. Clint ain't the best at reading. We just kind of do more of the survey and excavating for the main facilities.
Understood. Thank you so much.
We are still going to have to ask you to cease and desist until we get all this sorted out, though.
Now I can understand. Clint, or Cletus then speaks up. "Now I can understand that, and I can understand that. But you guys are gonna, we'll go ahead and pause for now. We'll give you guys a day just to make sure everything's going on. But if I don't make my quotas, I'm gonna be in deep. They're gonna put me down, man." So
I understand. We'll do really quick.
We're gonna go ahead.
Inside of two or three solar cycles, feel free to resume.
Huh?
Yeah.
What now?
If you don't hear anything inside of two or three solar cycles, feel free to resume.
I'm going to get shot in two or three solar cycles. I'll give you a day. You go and talk to Jeeves, and I'll...
Well, it'll take us about a day just to get there.
Well, that sounds like a you problem, mister. You see all these boys out here? Them's is me problems. I got to make sure these boys get fed.
True. Goodbye.
Feel free to build the steel lance refinery if it does turn out that you are perfect.
Oh, yeah, go ahead and let a bunch of lawyers argue about that crap while we sit here and starve. Yeah, all right, we'll let that happen.
That's literally their job, though, is to argue about this shit.
Lawyers ain't done nothing for us. You see this stuff out here? We earned this. Ain't no lawyer gonna come out here and help us.
Bye. What is everyone doing? Get in the ship.
We'll be in contact.
Or are we leaving?
A com number for y'all?
Yeah, it's 1-800, get the hell out of my sight.
we know where they are. It's not like they'll get far anyway. Thanks for your time, and have a good one.
Much appreciated. You too, sir. May the stars align for you.
Hey, you too.
Kisa would wave at them while the ship begins to start. Bye-bye.
What are you going to be doing with the squad? Because they're still just sitting outside the ship.
I'll just tell them to get back in. Wait, are we traveling by this thing, or are we actually supposed to be walking?
We have a
month and a half just to get there, and you'd probably asphyxiate just from the space.
Yeah. So, not me.
I have a...
Let's bring the squad.
Okay.
And, let's go.
All right.
Kisa waves. Where'd you guys go? To where Jeeves is.
Yeah, let's go wherever they pointed us to Jeeves.
Okay. So, with that, all of you pack back in, and you can hear the grunts kind of just aimlessly complaining about all the dust and stuff they're going to have to clean out of their weapons and stuff, as the ship is now a very nice hue of red from all the dust and everything. And the ship begins to take off and slowly makes its way over to where Jeeves has been reported. It's been, you guys got there probably like very early morning. It's now late afternoon, and it's like late, so I would say like, 7:30, 8 o'clock-ish, as you kind of pull up to the second facility.
Alrighty then.
Let me just... Oh god, I'm gonna do all this again. Give me a quick second here while I do all this.
while he repositions his Terran pawns.
And distributes some not SCBs, not other StarCraft models and whatnot.
I will be right back.
Okay.
He stayed up until 3 a.m.
I wonder what model the Jeeves will be. Maybe it'll be a Firebat. Maybe it'll be a Reaper, yeah. Or maybe a fucking. Oh, what's the fucking blank suit one's called?
It could be a Vulture.
Why am I pulling a blank?
A Vulture.
No.
A ghost?
No, not the ghost. The fucking. Is it Marauder?
The big
Marauder?
One?
The
yeah.
Yeah.
Marauder, that's it, yeah. That'll be Jeeves right there.
Or hell, he might pull out a wasted.
Damn, y'all have
to. I posted in the Discord.
Who am I missing? I'm missing Dog. There he is. Okay.
It'd be easier if we had characters.
It would, except I haven't. So you're gonna have to suffer.
So much suffering.
Mm-hmm.
I wanna die.
Dog, Saber.
Look at this happy boy. It's okay, Gus. You have this non-copyright music to.
Oh, fuck. I didn't even think about that.
I was using copyright assets.
Mute the music! Mute the music! No, it's video game music, so, I mean, it's okay. For whatever reason. Okay.
As long as you don't make a profit off of it.
Yeah. Alright. Land and, you know, the dropship slowly kind of works its way down, settles with absolutely no issues, and you guys all unload onto this, what Cletus had described as the second outpost. Let me. Okay, cool. They were objects. Good and cool.
All right, I'm back.
Wonderful. So, as you guys kind of look forward into the brightness, you're actually only able to see a little bit further in, but you can kind of clearly make out the outskirts of the. It looks a lot more like a small village.
Clickety clack.
Clickety clack, motherfucker!
Go ahead, okay. Whenever you guys are ready.
Alright, same deal. Find this Jeeves, tell him he needs to cease and desist, blah 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 blah. Alright, let's go.
Hello?
As you approach, same thing kind of happens, except you can kind of see deeper into the base this time, and it's a lot more hustle and bustle. There's a lot more kind of people moving about, as you can see a lot more of the small transport units kind of moving between the refinery and the
man. Oh, shit, we even got the engineer station and a fucking barracks. These boys have got a nice little early game base, though. How the fuck they got a starport already? Damn, this is some pro strats right here.
One of the guards raises his hand again and says, "Hey, what are you guys doing here? State your business."
Looking for Jeeves.
Why?
We have documents to get to work.
What the hell? I don't need four voices. Who's your leader?
Not
the Kaiser.
Alright, what do you want?
We got some official business with Jeeves.
One at a goddamn time. And you see, with the shouting, quite a few of the other armed guards kind of make their way towards you.
Dun, dun, dun.
Now, what are you saying?
We got some official business with Jeeves.
Okay, for what?
About your, how legal the market here is.
We've got orders. What do you mean this is illegal?
Well, we've got a road contract here stating that, well, this entire planet's been, purchased by another company, so,
What do you mean? We have the rights to that.
Well, apparently not anymore. You wanna take it up? You'll have to talk to the, hang on.
Talk to Steel Lance Refinery.
Steel Lance Refinery Corporation.
The, Marine kind of looks at his buddies a little bit concerned. He's, you know, he's just kind of looking around a little bit anxiously, and, he makes a little gesture, towards the Marine in the far back and says, "Go get Jeeves." And you can see the Marine begins walking into the, main processing center and disappears for a couple seconds.
I do have documentation to support our claims.
Who are you people?
We are workers of Steel Lance Refiner.
You work for Steel Lance? The hell?
Well, not directly.
What are you here for?
We're being contracted by them.
Alright, so who are you?
Mercenaries for the Black Star. Mercenary.
You can see all the Marines immediately kind of Their guns go from a down to a bit of a more
ready stand. I knew that would happen!
Hey, now. No need to raise your
guns. Hey, we don't want no trouble, alright? We're just here, we're simple miners, alright? We don't want any business with y'all.
Yeah, yeah. Don't cause no trouble, we won't cause no trouble.
Well, says you, you brought guns!
So,
well,
you also
brought
guns
too!
Have you seen? We've shot 14 wild critters out here. We're just trying to protect ourselves. You wouldn't come out here without a gun. What are you?
Well, we didn't know how much you were going to cooperate, so we just wanted to be prepared. Can't say you can blame us.
Also, if you have to fear from wild animals, we have to fear from wild animals. So you got
you got that chip. We don't.
You can complain all you want. You're literally being a pussy and hiding stealth.
This guy is just always pulling a gun.
I'm just gonna.
Okay, but you're not being
one of the pillars for the building here.
Hey, get off that.
What? I'm just leaning here.
Get off. Hey, you want to clean it when your nasty ass foot gets off it? Then you can do that. But we have to keep this place clean. You see all this dust?
So I just sit down on the floor next to them.
I suppose that's fair. I would have given up cleaning this place a long while ago.
Yeah,
we
have to.
You don't want to deal with us, Eva. We're just doing our job. You're trying to do yours.
Yeah, so are we. And
that's why
we
just want to make sure this gets done with nice and smoothly. You can go on your merry way.
You guys continue to bicker. What appears to be a very, very bulky man exits the facility, and he brings a couple more people.
Hey, Marauder!
I'm going to,
people kind of make space for him. What the?
I'm going to, activate my, camo cloth, so I'm going to,
okay.
Go into, hidden state.
Okay. Hang on a sec. Okay, as you do that, all the guards immediately raise their guns and go, "What the hell are you doing?" And they begin to immediately fan out.
Saying the who? As in, like, all of us in general? Is he on about because dog's trying to stealth?
He's just pointing at the guy down the way that's turning invisible. What are you guys doing?
Of course.
You are now partially invisible. Or you're translucent, at least.
Yeah, it takes 10 seconds, so it's not something that takes long.
Jeeves, I'm assuming.
What?
We're here on behalf of the... I'm gonna fucking forget in it.
Steel Lance Refinery. It's in
Steel Lance Refinery Corporation.
You're here with... The guard immediately interjects. I thought you said you were mercenaries. What the hell?
I said we're here on behalf... We are still mercenaries, we are just working for them temporarily.
He immediately waves his hand and kind of begins to walk away. I don't got time for this, alright? Get your goons and get out of my sight.
Look, you're mining illegally.
What the?
And as such, we have to ask you to relocate.
We have the proper documentation. Now get off my lands, or I'm gonna get you off my land.
As do we, right here. Now pull out the fucking document.
Jeeves immediately pulls out his revolver and shoots the data slate that was on the information that had the contract.
That was extremely
rude. That's how it's gonna be, yeah.
That's how it's gonna be if you want to make a move, or you can get the hell out of my sight.
Or you can get the hell out of our sight. Ah, sorry.
We're just trying to do our job. If you want to make it hard for us, we can make it. We can make our lives quite as easily as difficult.
Well, you can either make me move or I'm staying. I ain't going nowhere. And I'd like to see you try.
Ghost?
Hmm?
I'm gonna use take him out.
Okay.
Take me out. Take me out.
Okay, what does it do?
I assume.
I get a +2 to my attack roll.
Well, it's a skill. It's a skill thing.
What does it do?
It's a skill trigger thing, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Basically, he just gets +2 to his attack roll.
Take someone out. Kill or disable someone quickly and quietly.
He's going to try to sneak up
from
and,
up close
okay.
and personal
sure.
or
go
from
for
a
it.
Distance.
Go for it.
So it's a. Yeah.
Okay. So it passes, and let me.
Sugar.
2, 3, 4. Alright. As you do that, two of the Marines immediately begin to open fire at you.
Right, so as you could all probably tell, it is now a hostile environment.
So go ahead and roll to take down Jeeves, and then.
I don't. Whatever.
Well,
isn't
that the first roll
he did
with the roll
of
taking
Jeeves? Yeah.
So Aiden, and then the reaction shots from the Marines as a man who was invisible shows up behind to take out their leader.
Oh no, I'm still invisible. I want to
no, well. Man. Oh yeah, yeah.
Oh, as soon as you attack or make a skill check,
yeah,
you lose invisibility as soon as you engage combat.
No, it's only if I take damage.
The homebrew.
You lose hidden. If you, it specifically says you lose hidden if you attack or force somebody to make a skill check.
Yeah, but I want that invisibility thing because it get a 50% chance to miss. So
you're okay. Still
I'm not hidden. I'm not hidden, but I'm.
You're translucent, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
So again, go ahead and roll for damage on Jeeves.
We don't roll?
I thought it was kind of just...
Oh, sorry. Yeah, my bad.
You don't really survive, like, your neck Jesus getting slit. Down.
So, as Aiden, you suddenly appear inside this kind of gaggle of Marines, and they immediately freak out. Now, I'm assuming with the takedown you're using a knife?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I have a sword. I just, like, sword. Sword. Slash head. Pretty much head is on the floor now, rolling around, you know.
So you pull out your sword, and the guards immediately panic. And before they can raise their guns to immediately react, you basically clean cut Jeeves from the neck across. So it's a quick slice motion, and you can see this giant, almost Terminator-looking body just slump to the floor. As you do that...
Can I interject here?
What?
I want to make a take control check for the rest of the guards.
Okay.
To convince them to stand down.
Sure, go for it.
That is roll 1d20 plus 2. I think that's...
Oh!
Nah. When?
The Marines begin to raise their guns and basically turn what Grit was initially a human being into a pile of spaghetti sauce on the floor. And Taryn, you need to say something to get them to lower their guns.
Stand fucking down. Do you want to end up like him?
No.
We are going to compare the documentation. I've got electronic copies of our documentation. We are going to compare documentation. We are going to work this out peaceful-like. Got it?
Peace.
Okay. Yeah, that. Oh, Jesus.
Where did Jeeves. Where is Jeeves' office?
Inside the building.
Where else? Well, we are going to go to Jeeves' office, and one of you is going to show me where his documentation is.
One of the Marines that was kind of standing next to Jeeves kind of steps forward and goes, all right, look, we don't want anything. Just follow me and we'll go. Okay?
All right. Right. You two go deal with that then. We'll, keep an eye on these a lot then.
And
who's my trim again?
Right? Yeah.
Montauk?
Like, who's Matrim? Is that Dez?
Or no, that's Taran.
Oh, that's Taran.
Yeah.
Damn, fucking nat 20. Damn.
Yeah.
Lucky motherfucker.
Yeah. It was a nat 20 on a take control of the situation, too. So
fucking...
Managed to cancel combat effectively.
So, the Marine kind of follows you in. Two Marines follow you in. Is anyone else going with you?
Is anyone else coming with me?
I'll go in.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So as you two go in here, actually, I'll... Saber and Taran.
Oh.
Oh, what?
Everyone is dying. No, right. I just have a chat. Talk? It's okay, we still got the StarCraft music.
StarCraft music's okay with me.
We don't know about Black Star's, like, not background, but I guess, like, as soon as you told him that we were a part of Black Star, he raised his guns.
No, so. they were bitching at us because of the Steel Lance Refinery.
No,
I didn't say that we were from the Black Star to these guys.
Yes, you did.
I said we were working for the Steel Lands.
Hey, Ghost, I'm gonna
as
try
mercenaries,
to go
yeah. Again. Ghost isn't here, Aiden.
Where'd he go? Oh.
He's talking with those two, yeah.
I thought he was still here.
Oh, well. Yeah, as soon as he said Black Star, they raised their guns and was like, we don't want
any either way, though. It doesn't fucking matter, because A, no one else is contributing, and B, they were gonna fucking attack us either way! Because our team leader isn't doing anything!
I told you guys what to do, you just gotta follow...
No, you only told us what
there is nothing we can do
combat.
If they are instantly going to be aggressive towards us.
So, we did...
And assassinating their leader, true, it is giving us more time, but at the same time...
And an immense advantage.
Not really!
No,
that other group of people were answering to Jeeves. For all we know, the bigger settlement also probably works for Jeeves. Maybe.
And
I don't know.
You just killed Jeeves. What if we just probably created a war?
Yeah.
We just probably made our job a hell of a lot harder.
Yeah.
I think you're forgetting. But okay.
Forgetting what?
Never mind.
No, you literally cut out, so...
Yeah, you actually cut out, though.
Never mind.
Angry.
I'm not angry.
No, I am angry.
No, we're angry, because we want to know what the fuck you said, but you cut out, and now you're like, no, I'm not going to tell you what I said.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I was thinking to myself, it's fine.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to die.
Like, not all of us can fucking just suddenly assassinate people and be like, ah, oh, this is fine, haha.
We'll be fine.
I'm gonna die. Oh, poor Keith.
I'm just gonna walk back to the ship and leave you all to fucking die at this rate, like.
We'll be fine.
Why are you guys in separate channels now?
Ghost is talking to them about something. I don't know, really.
It's secret. What is this music?
StarCraft. You Jesus. Uncultured shit.
Shut the fuck up, dog.
One way to easily trigger Dez, just tell her she's uncultured for not playing StarCraft. Wait, why'd you roll a d20?
Who the fuck are you talking to, dog?
Saber.
Saber is with Ghost.
Oh.
Jesus Christ. This is why you don't do drugs, kids.
This is why you don't assassinate an NPC party's leader.
It'll be fine.
You literally probably created a war.
How?
Well, think about it. This
well,
whole
company.
We just killed one of their managers.
I don't think this is more like a big time company. I think it's more just like these lot.
True, but now we're gonna have like you know the little raiders, like raiders.
A bunch of hillbillies. What are they gonna do?
What I think will probably happen because like this is the medium sized settlement in it. Mm-hmm. We've still got the big one to deal with, which is gonna have
exactly.
even more people.
It's gonna be.
They're not gonna be too pleased about us, you know, fucking killing off their guys.
We're screwed.
Wait, is Saber? Wait, Aiden, are you trying to assassinate the Marauder?
He already did.
He's dead.
Yes.
Oh my god, dog.
Sorry.
Fuck's sake.
So, you two return out into the main area, and as the rest of you have noticed, there's a sizable amount of additional guards kind of coming out of what seems to be the
Marines, boys.
Seems to be the
Marine ball.
The the base crew barracks. Please don't sue me, Blizzard.
I mean, you're using the art, like, you're already, like, too far in.
Just using the models, good god.
Right. Yeah, just using the models, the music, and the turns, it's fine.
So, as you guys kind of stand around, you notice there's more and more people inside these environmental suits, kind of just looking over at Jeeves' basically decapitated body. It's getting into quite a crowd, and you can hear a lot of them starting to kind of mumble and rustle around you.
After reviewing the documentation found in G's office, it has been determined that this operation mining here is illegitimate and illegal.
Says you! From the crowd.
Ah, yes, of course.
Feel free to submit it for review.
You killed our boss, you bastard!
He was doing illegal things.
You so, tried to attack us!
We didn't do anything to attack you until you shot at us!
Well, what do you want us to do then?
Nothing. Leave. That's the point.
If y'all are willing to pack up and leave within a reasonable time frame, we will not take any further action against you.
The crowd just kind of idles there, not really sure what to do.
I'm going to at least take aim on this marauder and just prepare it.
Who is the next in line for command here?
The guy kind of closest to you raises his hand a little sheepishly. Dog, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm just waiting.
He's measuring distances.
I'm just waiting.
I'm going to need you to take command here and get this facility ready to be packed up and moved out inside of, say, 10 solar cycles.
He just kind of nods his head and kind of herds the rest of the soldiers back into the facility to begin deconstructing it.
Oh, yeah. Well, go ahead, sorry.
We are now going to go have a talk with Jeeves' boss, and we'll be back to check on you afterward. If y'all could send some sort of communication to the other outpost, the one to the southwest, and let them know of this, that would be great.
They don't really respond. They kind of just head in quietly, looking... Every once, you'll see a couple eyes glance over at the headless body of Jeeves, and they just kind of, they just shoot daggers. They don't really say a whole lot. They just kind of look at you in anger.
In spite.
I mean, with Jeeves being dead, there's not a whole lot we can do.
Yeah.
Thanks, Aiden.
It became a lot more subservient, though.
Yeah, but everything has become a lot harder now as well.
Has it?
They're listening to us at the moment. For at least.
And I thought it would be fine.
Plus,
so.
You're saying we're gonna go talk to Jeeves' boss. I don't think that his boss is gonna appreciate the fact that we fucking killed him.
here's something interesting. I mimic Jeeves' voice. I think I have it covered.
How can you do that?
God, are you gonna walk into the. Are you gonna walk
Well, you might want to also get a suit on then, I guess.
Yeah.
Jeeves.
Which, by the way, takes about 10 minutes.
Can you bring the suit with us on the, or like,
transport.
Yeah can we?
I mean, you can.
Rob Jeeves' body.
Again,
Jeeves' body's still in the thing.
Right.
Word travels fast, and if they hear that, if they see that you're mimicking him, and they ask you a question that you have no answer to,
remember, no Russian.
Yeah.
Don't disrespect his body. You killed him. Let's go.
I'm trying to
remember. Okay, I'm going to.
Your hollow gadget can mimic his suit anyway.
Look.
Oh, God.
Right.
We're not helping you with this. Just fucking. You're gonna do it. Ugh, I want no part of it.
Yeah, I'm,
What are the usual traditions for dealing with bodies on these kind of stations?
You guys know that we're mercenaries, right?
Yeah, doesn't mean we're cold-blooded killers that'll kill anyone just randomly.
Except for Aiden.
No, I would, but I'm at least a little smarter about it.
I'm reformed, fuck you all.
Quirk's a psychopath. I specifically said that he is a psychopath.
No, you never did.
You never said. And if he was a psychopath, he wouldn't be...
Literally, all we know of your character is he's a Canadian. That likes to copy people. That's it.
That's more of a sociopath than a psychopath.
So a ghost?
Hmm?
No, that was the bot leaving.
Ghost. What?
Yes.
Why the bot leave?
I'm trying to ask a question, guy.
Okay.
So what's the usual way to deal with dead bodies on these kind of stations?
Kaiser, I was the first one.
They're just going to kind of, it's more of a ceremonial thing, as they are nomadic, their entire people are very nomadic, so the way of the wanderer is more of to let their body rest where their body is laid. So they'll very likely kind of remove him from his armor and then bury him quite literally where he died.
Wow. Alright.
The hillbillies are nomadic.
So
interesting.
It's They're not going right. to, again, they see it more as a, because the body can travel everywhere, the spirit might get lost trying to find where it has been. And so the cultural belief is to lay the body exactly where it was, or the soul might get lost.
The spirit can find it.
Correct. So the Marine that's kind of next to you just waves you away and says, don't. This is ours. Don't, you know.
Not touch.
No. I said I left it alone.
And you can see a couple people begin to kind of quietly remove the armor of Jeeves and bring it inside with the blood still quite literally flowing out off his torso with the head removed, and people are beginning to kind of cover it in sand very delicately.
I'm going to press F to pay respects and go on my way.
Fair enough. Alright, the squad loads you back in, and is there anything else you guys want to do?
Seems we just gotta go into the next area, I guess.
Yeah.
We have no choice.
Shouldn't take that long to get to the big one, at least.
We should probably at least swing by the green outpost again, just to let them know on our way to the red.
We have to backtrack.
We're on a time limit.
I mean, we could fucking, it won't be much of a trouble to tell the small group first.
Dom isn't going to punish you guys for actually being late. He just wants to make sure you don't fuck around for too long.
I mean, we've only spent, like, one day, technically?
Essentially.
Yeah.
This is the end of solo cycle one. We have 5. So yeah,
like it wouldn't take us that long to swing by over to the green one, but it'll just take us a lot longer to get to the red one.
I suggest going to the green one because said they're going to restart mining if we don't come back. Yeah, right.
You know, I just realized we didn't grab anything saying about from Jeeves or anything.
Oh, I pulled up once. Yeah, I got his laptop.
Okay. Well, this information was not divulged to you at this time.
Yeah, so I wanted to make sure we were out of the fucking outpost. I wasn't going to pull it out next to his buddies.
Alright, yeah, let's head over to the green one then, because that's just going to be a quick and simple thing.
Alright. So, TL, we're going to the green?
Yes.
Yes.
Y'all not TL.
Alright. The pilot kind of straps in and goes, oh, Jesus, here we go again with the delivery system, and begins to fly you guys back. You can take this time, since you're going to be doing essentially a full night's rest on the ship, so it's not going to be the easiest thing to sleep on, but you do get 8 hours, slash if there's anything you guys want to do.
Yeah, slept on worse.
While the pilot flies you, now is your opportunity to speak freely.
All right, I'm going to stay in the ship and mimic what's-his-face. But I won't come out unless they need some more convincing. And then I'm going to for the best.
I'm going to look through...
The miners here were pretty cooperative. I don't think they'll need too much more convincing.
Yeah, so I just want you to keep your comms on so I can hear what they're saying.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
I'm going to go through some of the... Like, essentially the dude's laptop on the way. And see if there's anything that might be interesting about, like, I don't know, maybe... like any kind of trying to find anything that might be useful, interesting things or whatever. Yeah.
Okay. Real quick before we start, let's take a quick top of the hour break. So I'll give you guys 7 or 6 minutes to run to the bathroom, get some water, get some snacks if you need, and then we'll come back at the top of the hour. Okay.
All right.
Cool. All
right. See you guys in a bit.
I think so.
So, you guys, after a nice, kind of rough 8 hours of flying, arrive back. Now, please remind me, did anyone do anything while on the ship?
Not really, as far as I'm aware.
The data.
Besides looking at the laptop,
besides looking at the laptop.
Okay. No one else.
Now again, Saber, I'll PM you because you were the only one that looked at it.
That's whack.
Secrets. Gonna find out he's got a secret affair.
There you go.
Cletus.
Now,
having an affair with his wife or something.
I'm going to say this to all of you, so that way you understand. When you guys do kind of split off from the main group, it is probably a good idea that you communicate to each other what you have seen slash found, because I'm not going to tell all of you. So if anything is vital or important, it's probably a good idea to share it.
Weep detected.
Hey, all right, fine, whatever, man.
Well, do you not have the music playing, Ghost?
No, I don't, because I want to make sure Dog doesn't copyright me and then...
Yeah, I was using NCS.
Yeah.
You're good.
Alright, cool, thank you.
Yeah, so long as the stream is inherent, it's fine.
Right.
Yeah, it was okay.
You could still listen to it, you know.
That's true. Is it, you'll never see it coming?
No.
I'm using NCS at least, I can't say the same about the...
Is it synthetic?
Yes.
Okay, so... You guys show up back at the outpost. What are you doing?
Before we leave the ship, like as we're heading out, I want to mention that there wasn't anything interesting in the data computer thing.
Yeah. TL?
He's already hidden himself again.
Is Aiden dead? Ah, there he is. What are you guys doing?
Didn't I already explain? Alright, I'll do it again. I'm gonna mimic Jeeves and stay in the ship until, and I'm gonna get you guys to go out again and talk to them. If they need more convincing, then I come out as Jeeves and say to pack up. So leave your comms live so I can hear what's going on. Yes? Alright. Now go.
Nah, I think I'll just chill her.
I mean, you do...
lead on this then?
Were you talking to our group or their group? I didn't understand that at the beginning.
Oh. Aiden, take the initiative. You're leading the squad.
I just.
Rally the goons, man. Sometimes they're dumb.
I'm gonna approach the guards. I'm gonna look for the guard I was talking to last time.
Okay. Now what do you want? I thought I told y'all that we was gonna unpack everything. What do you want?
We went and talked to Jeeves.
Yeah, what about him?
After reviewing his documents, we've determined that it's exactly as we told you, and y'all need to pack up and leave town, essentially.
Well, I can't do that, Mr. What was your name again?
My name is Hector.
Hector?
Hector.
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 Is that with an E or a C?
H-E-C.
Heck.
Hector.
How the hell did you get O-R?
Just call him Heck for the time being.
H-E-C. God damn.
H-E-C-T-O-R. Happy now?
Yeah, well, maybe if you'd just gone and spelled it right the first time, you hillbilly looking son of a bitch, you would have gotten it right the first time. Jesus Christ. Hey, but Jebediah, come on over here. Fucking hillbillies are out there weird shit again. As he yells that, the guy that apparently is Jebediah moseys over, and a couple of the other, you notice there's a few more people that are armed this time, as as the group draws near, you notice that there's quite a few more armed personnel this time. There's not nearly as many workers going back and forth between the refinery and the processing facility.
Great.
Now, what y'all want?
As I said, we have contacted Jeeves, and the result of our contact was that this facility needs to be taken down.
And I told you, sir, or I told one of you at you, young lady, I remember giving you a map. I know you was here. We are going to hold off our facilities. I have contacted Jeeves, who's unavailable at the time. I don't know where he went, but I told him to tell George that we are going to hold off until y'all's have figured out what the hell's going on here. We don't want nothing.
All right.
Figure out what was going on, and what's going on is y'all need to take this down.
Well, I ain't gonna move a finger until my boss tells me to move a finger. That's how I get in trouble, mister.
Your boss is Jeeves, right?
Huh?
Your boss is Jeeves, right? Let me contact
him. No, it's George.
No, I think they answer the Jeeves, because what she said, hey, we're not going to do anything, go talk to Jeeves.
No, he said, tell Jeeves that we're, tell George.
Let's give orders from in order for you to
I answered to Jeeves.
Alright.
Jeeves answers to George. I don't know what the hell y'all don't understand about this. It's a simple hierarchical structure. Y'all ever worked in a facility before?
Yeah, Jeeves is in the shuttle back over there.
Yeah. Hey, pack up, boys. We're good here.
All the guards immediately raise their guns at all of you.
All right. It was worth a shot.
I want all of you to get the hell out of my sight. I know what you did to our boy. Now get the fuck out of my sight or I'll open fire.
Boys, I'm right here. Shut up. Shut up. Yes, I swear to fuck. Ghost.
What?
Don't worry, boys, I'm fine. It was just a slight miscalculation on our half. I'm fine.
Roll initiative.
Initiative?
All of you.
What's the dice?
There is no initiative.
Roll a
ghost. I can't try and convince them.
No.
You have the initial tracker, Ghost?
You spent the entire night.
They fucking killed Jeeves. That's A done!
That doesn't mean I can't lie and try and convince
them
otherwise.
They know we killed them!
That doesn't mean I can't lie and try and convince them otherwise.
Roll initiative. We'll get this. We're not gonna do hard combat. We're gonna just try and do it the Lancer style.
I don't wanna deal with this.
I'm having a fucking blast. I love this.
I'm not having fun.
Why? This is awesome.
Oh, I'm sorry, mister. I'm just gonna randomly kill people because, haha, XD got him.
He's a psychopath? Because it's part of his character?
Me and Kaiser tells you it's a bad idea. Aiden does it anyway.
There's something you're misunderstanding about psychopath.
TL, roll for the soul.
It just doesn't make sense.
Whatever, I'm just gonna fucking sit AFK. You guys have fun.
How are you gonna be so shy and then do stupid shit like this? It just doesn't make sense.
The soldiers then. Alright, so I'm gonna mark.
How did he ever become team lead?
You
because
guys.
Because he was actually competent last session.
What do you mean, competent?
You elected him. Don't look at me.
Yeah, you weren't being a murderous sociopath last time. Now you're just all I'm a murderous sociopath. No, you weren't.
To be fair, he was stuck in a mech the entire last session.
No, not really. He was just invisible the entirety of last session, which he is again now.
That's
nothing has changed.
Yeah.
Except the scenario. Oh, there's more people. Okay, so you just want to kill them. Okay.
Fighting was inevitable anyway.
It wasn't, but okay.
What? What the fuck were you gonna do with Jeeves there? He was pointing a gun at you. He even said that you're gonna have to move him if you want to get rid of him. You were getting nowhere with that. I'm sorry, but no.
Yeah, yeah, and if you've just made everything harder by killing him and made the entirety of this operation. No, listen.
No, you could have disabled him without killing him, and that would have
been the
made
entirety of this operation
easier.
Is now a hell of a lot harder because you killed Jeeves. We have
yes!
this okay.
camp and the big camp to now deal with.
Okay, look.
The big camp gonna be a hell of a lot fucking harder because, you know, we have to deal with the entire village worth of rednecks plus whatever they have geared with them.
Okay, look. Look. It's already happened. There's no changing the fact that we killed Jeeves. So we need to get in, prepare for combat. Because it's inevitable at this point.
Yeah.
I'd rather just go back to
this
ship and not do.
So either we pull the fuck out of here and regroup and prepare for combat, or we go now and wait for people
to
move into position again.
What was the name of Jesus' boss again? I don't remember.
George.
Yeah, we can go try and find George, and that's our best option at this point if we want to avoid combat. Why did you put the move order in little in spicy memes?
Oh shit, wrong channel. XD. Might be.
Can you activate the roll 20 initiative and we can use that?
Thing? Oh yeah, roll 20 has an initiative thing. That's
yeah. It's
Wait,
the
it
icon. It looks like a clock on the left and the next to where you have a
yeah
there.
But I thought that there was an issue with.
And you just right click our tokens and do add turn and then we can
oh,
enter
really?
It. Yeah.
Okay.
It's not that. It's
right,
a lot
I can't
easier
do that.
No, I. All right. Sure. All right. So right click. Oh, add turn. Cool.
Yeah, you can
all
just
right.
do that for all of us and then we can.
Yeah,
we should
yeah,
be
yeah.
able to all enter. Right.
That works. That works.
And then we have to roll initiative.
No, we already rolled
you
it,
already
so we just have to type it in.
Yeah, you already did. Don't worry about it. Aiden, and then Taryn, and then Saber, Dog. Shit.
Yeah, I can type it.
Did
okay.
all of the guards just collectively roll crap?
No, they just they're a collective group, so I'm gonna have them go at the end of the turn since all of you. Already rolled Saber, Squad B, Kaiser.
Because the official Lancer combat is we just take turns going.
Yeah, well that's why I'm having you roll initiative.
House All rule.
Right. Alright. Des, you're first. What are you doing?
Well nobody rolled their initiatives then.
Do you want to reroll?
No, I mean yeah, like on the turn order thing, you can click on where it says zero for your number and you can enter your number like I put mine. Or unless you just want to use that.
I mean, if I just click the next arrow, it should just move to the next person, so it should be fine.
I mean, it's based on values normally.
Let's just go with this, it's okay.
Alright.
We'll live. Yes, what do? Again, you guys are in more of an RP combat, so I'm not going to have you guys rolling anything crazy.
I would like to try and persuade the dudes.
Okay.
Do you have a persuasion trigger?
I do not. So it's just roleplay.
Alright. They all have their guns trained at each one of you right now. So the left side is kind of looking at the translucent dog. The soldier closest to you...
I'm hidden, unless they're specifically looking for me.
You have... Oh, okay, so you're full hidden, my bad. Alright.
Yeah.
Might update it to the ninja icon.
Yeah. There we go. And then Aiden also still has the full hidden.
No, because he just announced himself, Romella.
Yeah, I'm
so he's visible.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so then these front three... Kaiser, the one closest to the command center is aimed at you, the other two are aimed at Taryn. Two in the back are aimed at Des, and the one on the far right is kind of keeping an eye on the squad, who is now spaced out, but still hasn't moved. So, Des, what would you like to do?
I would like to yell out, you guys are on private property now, and yes, our friend... Or ex-friend over there killed your boss.
We weren't. Okay.
But he had the right to do so because he was being in What is it when you don't,
threatening?
Yeah, he was threatening us, and also he wasn't cooperating. There we go. So we had no choice, though I agree he had no reason to kill him. But we don't need to continuously kill each other now. Simply leave, and it'll be done with.
Roll a 1d20 with disadvantage.
I have an idea what disadvantage means.
Minus one.
Roll twice.
No, is it the d6 in this game?
No, roll a 1d20 and then roll a 1d6.
Right.
With disadvantage. Because she's rolling to try and persuade, but then her their boss was literally murdered. So yeah. Des, you say you open up your heart to these miners, and it falls on deafened helmets. They are still running to gun all of you.
Okay.
Squad 1. So, Aiden, what is Squad 1 doing?
Which one is Squad 1, green or red?
Green.
Green.
Squad 1's gonna advance.
Okay. So, are they just, they're just going to move then?
Yeah.
All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. And they fan out.
Yes, thank you.
Okay. Is that it?
Yep.
Okay, Aiden, your turn.
I'm going to go full in this. So, hidden.
Okay. So, that's your turn then?
Yeah.
And Taryn.
Would trying to persuade them again be considered a quick action?
It would be no. A turn. At this point, I don't think it's possible within anybody's skill level to persuade them out of combat.
It is possible, it's just unreasonable.
You can try, you're just, as Des did, you're going to be taking disadvantage again because it's escort.
Okay, so it's not terrible for me because I do have a trigger that applies.
If you have the steel calm under pressure or whatever, I can...
Stay cool.
Well, I've got the take control trigger.
Okay.
Which is use force, violence, presence, or will, or direct action to take control of something, including situations.
Sure, roll for it. I'll give it to you.
Alright.
So, no disadvantage because of that option.
Would doing that... Alright, I'll do it in this order then. I'm gonna use my first quick action to proc that skill, to proc that trigger,
mm-hmm.
and make that roll. Can I do it this way?
I don't know.
And then
stopping.
It depends on whether it passes or fails. Will it let me do that? It does. And it passes.
Well, you weren't supposed to roll with disadvantage.
Oh, I thought you said I was going to roll with disadvantage like this.
No, because...
No, it's because Death didn't have the ability.
Death didn't have the take control modifier.
Oh, okay. Persuade or whatever.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, so... The guards aren't going to immediately fire... Well, give us a speech.
Alright. I know the bozo who just came out of the shuttle is trying to imitate your boss, and... I admit that was a poor decision on our part, but we did legitimately go through Jeeves' files, and he has nothing to support a legitimate claim to this area. Meanwhile, we have legitimate paperwork from the corporation that says that they have the rightful mining operations in this area. I'm gonna ask you to stand down, and we can talk about this, okay? No one needs to get hurt here.
Cletus kind of looks at you, and he knows he doesn't want to go to he doesn't want to fight. I mean, he's a mining man. He's a simple boy, but he's not going to just roll over too kindly. I mean, he stands with his gun drawn, but you can see you've broken his resolve, if you will. He doesn't want to fight.
Makes a difference.
Sorry,
I have not drawn my gun. If that makes a difference.
Not really. Again, one of the team just masqueraded as their dead boss. And again, in this group's culture, this the
highly
to desecrate the body is an extreme offense. As again, it loses the soul.
We did not desecrate the body.
Yeah, but we're pretty much copying how he looks and sounds. That's kind of disrespectful.
Yes, disrespectful to his memory.
Right. So, again, he doesn't lower his gun. However, he's not going to open fire immediately, is what I'll say. So, your words get to him. But he's not going to stand down because he's afraid for his people. He wants to make sure that the rest of the people here at the facility don't get hurt because he decided to back down. Okay. You said you had an extra half turn or a half action?
An extra half turn, but since that passed, I'm not sure what to do with it. Okay. Because to do what my original plan was would be kind of a break of phase.
Well, it's your turn. It's your decision.
Yeah. I'm doing the best I can to make sure this doesn't turn out into just a huge gunfight.
Mm-hmm.
As a gesture of good faith, I am going to place my primary weapon on the ground.
Everyone still has their gun raised, but Cletus. Cletus is the only one to actually kind of lower his weapon in confusion. He's a bit perplexed as to what you're doing. Putting yourself in such a vulnerable situation. What are you doing, boy? We fit in a fight.
I'm still trying to resolve this peacefully. If you don't want to fight, I don't want to fight.
I'd also lower my gun, but not onto the ground, just lower it in general.
Cletus's entire stance has now changed. The rest of the soldiers are still kind of very, very, very trigger happy, but he has completely relaxed his posture. So his gun is now down at the ground, but he still has it.
It's not pointing at me anymore.
Correct. The others are still very much, very much trained on everyone else. I want to point out. All right, Merlin, your turn.
I want to support him, so I'm gonna. Again, I'm going to have my gun essentially lowered.
Okay.
Compared to what my image looks like. And okay. Essentially, what was the name of his character?
Who's?
Yeah. His name's Hector. Yeah.
That's Hector?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Hector.
So I'm gonna kind of like support him and go in the same direction of like where he's going.
Okay.
Saying, so as my good friend Hector here is saying, and we don't want to fight unnecessarily. Obviously, you guys don't seem to be people that want to see that. I want to use my like take control also situation,
okay.
Trying to play into like the essentially. Well, yeah. So the angle I'm going is like I'm a doctor. I've seen like a lot of people like get hurt and stuff, and I don't want this to happen here.
Sure, give them, try and persuade them.
Oh,
nice. Did better than I did.
Okay, gotta give them a speech. Give them a speech, doc. You gotta convince the people.
All right.
I want to add in just real quick to break the illusion. If you want to take an action, say that you're going to take an action, but then. Do like say what you want to say and then roll. So don't roll and then if it fails, then you kind of fuck it up a little bit. Just say what you want to say and then roll. If that makes sense.
Oh, okay. So they just have to roll it.
Yeah. For now, just go ahead and give us a heartfelt speech about war and all that, and then we'll move on.
All right. So yeah. So I see you guys are very strong. Honest miners here only trying to make money, and I can respect that. And our gang here, we're not here to, you know, ruin your day, and like we're not trying to like destroy your livelihood, but unfortunately with the current situation, we're in a position where we have to ask you guys to leave this place because of these essentially the orders that we have from our corporation. I'm sure that none of us wants this to turn into a bloodbath. I don't know about your experience on the planet, but I'm sure the conditions here aren't that so nice that you've never seen any kind of combat or people dying. And as a medical doctor, I've seen my fair share of people getting hurt and dying on the battlefield, and I don't want, and I think none of us want this situation to become another one of these kind of bloodbaths that people will be regretting. And I'm sure you all have families. You have mothers, fathers, sons or brothers. We don't want any of them to be missing their some of their family members because of some rash decisions. I'm sure we can come to an understanding and avoid any kind of bloodshed from this.
As you finish, Cletus is he's really confused. You can see there's a real fight going on in his head. The rest of the soldiers that have kind of congregated begin to look at each other a little bit unsure of what they want to do here. And Cletus has got his gun fully raised, almost like he's kind of shouldering it like against his body. And he's kind of trying to like scratch his head. He's confused. And he's hell, I don't know. Hang on, boys, hang on now. We might be jumping into some hot water here. What kind of insurance you got against us for us to make sure none of our boys are gonna get hurt? That's at the end of the day, I don't give two rats' asses of what happens here. I just want to make sure that we don't, you know, these are my kin, my family. What you did to Jesus, that's just mighty wrong. But hey, sometimes that's business.
Yeah, I get you. Like, here, our business isn't to, you know, slaughter people. That's not what we're here for. We're just trying to do our job to, you know, get the orders respected. And so, yeah, like, our goal isn't to harm any people here. If you're willing to cooperate with us, then there's no reason for us to cause any harm to any of your boys. And you can have my word as a practitioner of medicine that I'm not here to harm people. I mean, sometimes it was like, you know, you're on this planet, you have some wild creatures that attack you, but this isn't one of those cases. We're just trying to, you know, do what we have to do. You have your job, we have our job. We don't need to get any violence about this.
No, and I agree with you, sir. I can always respect a man of medicine, you know. Y'all ain't really trying nothing to harm nobody, but again, you see all this, and he points to the facilities, the refinery, the starport, you know. All this costs money, brother. And look, I ain't got the money to kind of cover all this. What are you going to get? I need something to make sure that whatever you guys are here to do, whether it's good or bad, again, I don't care. I don't give a damn at the end of the day. We need to make sure that this stays safe. What can we do to make sure that we ain't got no troubles with getting this stuff wherever it needs to go, wherever you guys need to get us to go?
If you cooperate, we can put in a good word with the owners of this area. And they should be able to either hire you or make sure you get out of here safely.
I'll make sure you're taken care of.
Okay. He looks back at you, Saber, and he holds out his hand and says, "Man to man, you look me in the eyes and you tell me you're going to do right by us."
I stole my pistol and grab his hand and look him in the eye and say, "We'll do everything in our power to make sure you guys are all safe, and we do what we need so that you guys can be all right."
He looks at you for a good long minute. I mean, he just looks into you. Doesn't say anything. He just looks at you.
I'm staying cool.
How about Saber for the next squad lead? Because he's awesome. Yeah.
He just looks at you and he says, "All right, I'll let you do what you gotta do. Don't hurt my people." And he lets go of your hands, and he kind of slowly backs away, kind of still keeping his body face to you guys. But then he kind of waves everyone off and begins to just more or less kind of turn and walk back towards the command center, kind of beckoning everyone back inside. And they all kind of just follow him. What do you guys want to do?
Wait, so
the group. All right, so yeah, it sounds like we've got this under control now. So just got to make sure we don't murder any other important people in broad daylight, and that should work out in the future.
Facts. Now, if we're lucky, we'll get to the third camp, and they won't immediately be hostile.
Oh, they probably are already. But we'll find out when we get there.
So, what are you guys gonna do? Just pile back in?
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, pile back in, make a note in the mission log that this particular encampment is willing to cooperate.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And you guys zoop, bop, boop de boo. Alright, is there anything you guys want to do? I'm assuming you guys are heading towards the final encampment?
Yeah.
All
right.
If we can get the final encampment in line, it's basically guaranteed the yellow encampment will come in line too.
During a transport, since we have a bit of
you basically have an entire
downtime. We have downtime. Yeah.
You have a full downtime. What's your question, Doc?
I don't know. Just kind of deciding what to do at the moment.
Okay.
I'm just going to gather some information.
About what?
Just about in general about, you know, what they've got at this final encampment and what sort of backing they've got, you know?
Sure.
What information about George can we find?
So, based off of the laptop that you find, George is, he's a humble man. I mean, he is your old traditional built from the ground up kind of boy. He, the group that he works with, this is the, let me pull up, hang on. There it is. The Jefferson Family Refinery they are a recognized business. They're a very nomadic traveling refinery group that has worked throughout the system. They have over a couple hundred employees, and as you saw from the three separate bases, essentially, they are successful. However, they are definitely known for kind of taking care of more lesser, buying up a bunch of, just swaths of planets just on discount almost. Yes. Yeah, and, you know, going in, doing initial geological surveys, and then mining any resources or ores or, you know, precious metals they find. So they're not incredibly well known, but they, if you look them up, or
if you know them, you know them.
Right. They have been recognized.
It's not just a bunch of random rednecks going, hey, we're a legal company. Ah.
Correct. So they are recognized. They have a very nomadic sense of culture, as in family. Family is, you know, what is it?
Comes first.
Family comes first. Yeah, they're your good old fashioned, you know, southern family, just with a lot of nieces, uncles, and nephews kind of working through and out. They're not that south, if you know what I mean.
They got the Southern Hospitality and...
They got the Southern Hospitality without the
other part of it, yeah.
They got the good part of the Southern Hospitality, not the yeehaw, this is a
They're from Georgia, not Alabama.
What are you doing, stepbrother? so, they're a very humble and proud. I mean, they have worked their whole lives/generations trying to get get what they can get. But,
yeah, it sounds like we're going to need to have a good talk with this George fella.
Are there any other questions? Any other questions?
Can't think of any.
Okay. Let's see.
All right, so.
All right, okay. So, as you guys finally set down after almost an entire day of flying, you're finally able to get out and kind of stretch your legs. I left you guys as is, so you can kind of. Oh, did I?
You might want to unhide like that entire section
no,
of the map.
That's intentional.
All right, so.
You can only see so far. I mean, it's just there's. This area is a lot more. I mean, it's entrenched. You can tell that this was the first place that they landed.
Oh no, they're in a factory. They're gonna have Goliaths and shit. Fuck.
They chose this place as the first base because it has a very high Algorium presence, and it's much easier to defend against the local wildlife / environmental hazards because of the Rocky Mountain features around the map.
So roll for initiative for this time.
You're not in combat.
What? Okay, but like, still, we have to have a turn order.
No, I mean, you guys can just kind of go
it's
in.
It's if we do end up bumping into hostilities.
Okay, well, I'm
using the turn order more as if you guys initiate combat, that's how things are going to play out. Okay. Where with this, you can kind of just go in whatever order as you want. Again, do as you want. As you see, as soon as you land down, there is a large presence of armed soldiers just kind of waiting for you.
Welcoming party.
Yeah, more or less. So, what are you going to do?
Ghost, I'm emerging out of the ship and full hidden.
Say it again?
Full hidden for when I come out of the ship.
Yep. Okay.
Same for me as well.
Okay. Uh-huh.
I got it.
Look at these two being the problem children. Sheesh.
I cannot take a single bullet.
I'm gonna be
What we should have done on the shuttle on the way over here? We should have made an appointment with George.
How the fuck are we supposed to contact him?
Yeah, it doesn't work.
Assuming we have reason.
Considering our ship apparently doesn't have fucking communications equipment. For
well,
some
for the
fucking
star.
Reason.
Planetary communications is a reasonable thing to have in the space future.
I want
to point out, just for the clarity, the Black Star has communication to your transport. The transport is able to communicate to any station on the planet. It's just when Des tried to use the space phone to contact her family on the other side of wherever they live, she was unable to make that call because, again, the phones are designed for internal communication, not external.
So the phones usually weren't hooked up to that part of the communication system.
Well, the phones were designed to communicate between people inside the ship.
Yeah, they were short.
Death asked for where's your phone, so the guide pointed towards the phone.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
So do we have comms where you can send a message to the station on the ground?
You can. I mean, you're already there.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to walk back in the shuttle and make an appointment over comms with George before confronting the guards, because confronting the guards hasn't ended well for us.
Yeah, I think we'll just, like, go back into the ship. Be like, oops, and then call him. Like, it's like when you're calling someone from across the street.
Mm-hmm.
Let's make an appointment with George real quick, and then we can start negotiating with the guards.
And then we can say we have an appointment.
Okay. So you guys wanted to use the in-game comm, or the in-game comms, Jesus.
The shuttle
communication?
Yeah.
Alright. Who's making the call?
Aiden.
Yeah.
Or no.
Whoever's our negotiator.
No, I think someone else should take lead now.
Alright, Hector.
Because,
the fucks?
You were the one that promised the miners. I say the doctor should take it.
The doctor
is
what
his actual name is.
Call sign is Merlin.
Merlin. I say Merlin should take it.
Alright. So how does the comms work? Is it just like you dial and it rings, or like is it you send a pre-recorded message, or
think about it like Space Skype? You're able to kind of open up the channels and you're able to see three distinctive dots. The first one being extremely far away, one being probably about a day's travel out, and then a third one basically saying within 2 miles.
So is it like? Yeah. So the way this thing works, is it like you record a message and it sends, or is it just like live calls only, or?
You can do both. I mean, it's think of like a basic communication phone. You can call and receive messages, you can leave messages. All of it comes through on when you walk inside the ship at the, like when you walk in, you're at the ramp. On the far end, kind of if you had gone through to the pilot station, there's a little terminal against the wall that kind of sections off between the drop pod and the pilots, of essentially like a little hollow console where you can communicate through like 3D imaging.
Sorry.
So okay. I'm assuming you're going to use the phone to try and contact.
I was typing that in so I remember the name. Yeah, so I'm going to open comms to try to contact the station. See if anything responds.
So, there's a beep for a comment. It's just a do-do-do-do-do. And then just your...
Yes, not Skype noises.
Do-do-do-do-do-do.
you just hear this, hello?
Oh no, it's phone guy.
Oh no.
Hello?
No, stop, no, George, no. Look behind you, George, purple guy. Ah! Anyway.
Right, let me get back in focus.
Oh, there we go. Okay, sorry. Yeah.
Okay.
Hello?
Yes, this is Merlin from the Steel Lance Refinery Corporation.
What's a Merlin?
It's a name.
Oh, you're Merlin. All right. How can I help you, Merlin from the Steel Lance Refinery Corp? You looking to do some business with us?
Looking to protect yourself or deal some damage?
Well, in a sense. See, we have orders. Out of character, can you remind me, like, what our orders were saying, like, specifically? Was just to have them leave, or, like...
Shut
down illegal mining operations on the planet.
Yeah.
Right. So we have orders and documentation that this mining operation in this station is not actually legal and legitimate.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been tasked with essentially putting an end to the illegal activities.
Okay, well, if you have something for the complaints department, call back. I can direct you to them. Hello?
Yeah. Character, what was the name of the leader of this station? Did we
George.
Know?
I'll be just right. Make an appointment with George directly.
Alright, well, actually, we had a message that we needed to speak with George from this station.
Oh, yeah, George. She's a nice lady. What do you need her for?
What?
Well, we would need an appointment to speak with her. We have documentation that we need to present her, and we would need to have an audience to be able to speak with her.
Let me take a look at my books here. Yeah, okay. Let's see here. Nope, that's Thursday. Can't do that. All right, we can fit you in next week on 14th. How's that sound?
Well, we're a bit in a hurry. Would it be possible to squeeze us in today?
Today, Jesus, boy. Let me see what, hang on. Hey, Charger, you free? Yeah, there's someone on the phone for you. No, I don't know, they've got some documents or something, I don't know.
Yeah, she says you can come on over. Just let the guards know you got a meeting with her. They'll clear you through.
Yep.
You make it quick, though. She busy lady. She runs the whole operation here. You know that? She multi-million-dollar lady.
Damn.
Merlin, let him know that I'm going to be sending the electronic copy of the documentation ahead.
Yeah, I'll pass that along to her.
All right, thank you.
All right, goodbye now. You hear a very distinct click as the hollow phone hangs up.
I send a copy of the electronic documentation to the same comm line.
Okay.
Well, I suppose...
let's head out and...
That went better than expected.
Yeah, that was the first part. Now, George, I guess. Now this is the second part where it gets hard.
Alright, who's going for the meeting?
I'm guessing me, and I want to bring Hector.
Alright.
I'm going in secret.
Okay.
I guess I'll wait here by the ship then.
I mean, anyone else wanted to come with?
Yeah.
Alright, then let's go.
You guys have got it, you know. Might not need it, it's fine. Have fun.
Yeah, make sure you're ready if anything, like if you hear like combat noises, you know, come and help us. I don't know how these people are. Alright, then we're gonna head over.
Okay, so you guys are gonna head towards the guards, right. They're gonna immediately stop you and say, what can I help you with, gentlemen?
And I'm gonna move over here.
We have an appointment with George.
Okay, who says?
Oh, we just spoke. Himself. Yeah, we just spoke on the phone.
With who?
The person given name.
But yeah, okay, I know who answers my phone, but I don't know you. Clearly, you don't even take notes if you don't know who you're having a meeting with. Yeah, we all know George. She's a nice lady. And?
Well, then ask one of your guys that are not too busy to go and check in with them. We'll wait.
He like turns around, clearly just kind of a pissy attitude. He kind of looks back and he begins. This man, you can tell that he's gotten a much more. His suit looks much better, if you will. He begins kind of discussing to somebody through his suit.
Ooh.
And
elite boys over here.
Begins kind of chattering and. He goes, all right, follow me.
I'll follow.
He kind of escorts you two. There is a total of five guards, two in the front, two in the back, and then one kind of walking alongside of you. The command structure itself, or the refinery, is much, much more well suited, if you will, compared to the other two that you've been.
Saber,
the one that you've been in, or actually no, it was you and Taryn. So, and the one that you saw, the initial one was a lot more. It was built for purpose. I mean, again, same thing, much like the Black Star's design. A lot of it is very space conscious. Every single, I mean, almost down to the inch, with many areas and facilities kind of having a dual purpose. This structure looks a lot more. It looks a little bit more blobbish, if that makes sense. Instead of being a nice circular kind of refinery, you can see that there's been extensions and additions added onto the facility, kind of with the intent of essentially long use at this location. The base clearly showing that it's been here for a while.
Yeah, it's been more built out than the other ones we visited.
Correct. So as you...
Yeah.
One of the grunts kind of grunts.
Grunts.
So as you two make your way in, you're led up some stairs, down a couple hallways, and then you're brought to a Georgina Jefferson, but everyone calls her George, based off of her grandfather.
Works for us.
And the guard kind of looks real close at you and goes, now don't do anything squirrely. We're going to have our guns on you. You make a single move, we'll turn you into all kinds of uglies.
Of course.
Am I holding my weapons then?
Oh no, go ahead and try and make a move. We'll be faster.
Okay. Can't say I didn't try.
And so they lead you into, it's a very gorgeous office. It's got white tile. You've been walking through and most of the facility has been kind of steel mesh cage at the bottom and or steel. Kind of
industrial.
Industrial, very much so. This office is clean. It's almost like you just walked into a surgical room with white tiling. You can see there's actually plants in here.
Whoa.
There's a giant mural behind this woman of what looks to be a much, much older man with very whited hair. He's extremely aged. But at the desk sits this 5'6", 5'7", not very frail, but you can tell that she hasn't worked in the mines compared to many of the people that are around her. Very long, almost dirty blonde hair with a very kind of strong face. And she kind of just looks at you and she stands up and says, what can I do for you, gentlemen?
We have been contracted to serve you a cease and desist letter for this planet.
And why should I abide by that after you killed one of my men?
To be fair, he shot at us first.
And why should I abide by murderers?
No, that was work.
Oh, that was work, killing one of my people.
I mean, it didn't really leave us a choice, but like I understand that's obviously not the outcome that any of us wanted. Unfortunately, what's happened you're not there. Unfortunately, what's happened happened, and I wasn't able to save him. Can't change the past. We're trying to do here is to finish our job that we've been contracted to, and hopefully we don't need any more of that violence. We're not here to you know, cause any kind of more distress on your people. We're just here to do what we gotta do.
She kind of turns away from you guys, facing out. I failed to mention, one of the walls is pure glass and looks down into the kind of the refining area. And she makes it like the sucking your teeth noise. Can't really do it well enough with the microphone to pick up. She goes, now boys, I've worked hard in a lot of my time. And you are right. Trying to bring this to a peaceful resolution. Do you know why we're here?
Assume it's for the materials the planet provides.
That's right. And how do people go about claiming things?
Mostly arbitrary distinctions and distance.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, gentlemen, do you have any sort of documentation to prove any of this?
Yes, we do. I sent you an electronic copy right before the appointment, and I have another electronic copy in my data player.
She snaps her fingers, and one of the guards pulls out a data slate for her and, you know, hands it to her. And she just looks down at it half a second, reads it over, and then looks back at you. And you can see she's upset about something. She's very fiery. She goes, gentlemen, now I can see that you have the legal documentation here, but we have better. And she begins to walk back behind her desk where there's a very large wooden cabinet and puts her hand on top of the what appears to be a wooden surface. But then you see a very light kind of green bar run across her hand. And then she, going from her hand facing it, she then lifts up her hand to just her thumb, and you hear a small hiss, almost like a pressure point just hit, was activated, and she lifts up her thumb, and you can actually see that the table has pricked her thumb. And then she kind of looks back at you for a couple seconds and waits as the cabinet begins to open up from the top with a very clear division down the middle as what appears to be a piece of a encased paper kind of comes up from the cabinet. And she goes, "Gentlemen, I want you to take a look at this." And she kind of gestures you two towards the cabinet.
I'll
move forward to examine the document in the cabinet.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and roll a perception.
Spot check?
Yeah, do a spot check.
I have spot also. Oh! Ooh, nice.
Perfect. So, when you walk up to it, you notice that it's old. This paper, dirt is younger than. Or dirt, it's older than dirt. It's still written on what appears to be parchment paper with ink. It has been decades since either of you have ever seen anything written on paper before, and this is quite literally written on cloth. Mm-hmm. And she goes, "Gentlemen, I want you to take a look at what the title there says." And it says, "Proof of purchase."
The planet, isn't it?
"Proof of purchase by the First Grand Project, certified and sealed by the Union." And it goes through and lists out essentially the entirety property is not only its current, its original solar position when the claim was purchased, as well as the amounts, the transaction, and the signature of the original Union Trade Administration staff that authorized the purchase. She then continues on and says, "Gentlemen, I want you to look down there at my grandpappy's name." And she, gestures you towards the name, and it says George Jefferson Davis, the original founder of the family. And she goes, "Now, when my pappy sank our entire family's savings, not only just ours, but my uncles and my aunts, and my nieces and nephews, we didn't just buy this planet. We gave it everything. We gave it our hearts, our souls, and if something came here and took it, we didn't got nothing. Now, I want y'all to think real, real hard now what y'all about to say for how we're going to come to some sort of resolution. Yeah, you got documentation, so do I, but mine outdates yours by a whole hell of a lot."
Would it be possible to have a digital copy of this documentation that you have here?
She snaps her finger again, and one of the guards says, "It's already been done."
All right.
Worst case, I could scan it with my data plating.
Yeah. So, well, this changes things.
Yeah. Would you happen to have any idea how the Steel Lance refinery could have come into documentation about this planet?
I have no idea, son.
Mm.
Those Steel Lance boys, I don't trust them for hell. For heck. But that ain't my business. This here planet is ours. We paid for it legally and honestly. And y'all ain't gonna take that from us.
That if we can prove that the planet is owned by you and your corporation, I am not willing to take the planet from you. Would you be willing to assist us in our research efforts to make sure that this documentation is still valid?
What do you mean it ain't valid?
I didn't say it ain't necessarily valid. It may be. Assuming nothing has happened, this document should still be valid. However, that doesn't stop us from currently having documentation that contradicts it. And would you assist us in confirming one set of documents or the other?
she looks off for half a second, just kind of nods her head. Do what you gotta do. What do you need, then?
We're probably... Let's see. What's the origin of the paperwork that we're hauling for the Steel Lance Corporation?
You mean...
Is it internal documentation from Steel Lance Refinery, or is it union documentation?
It was a cease and desist letter provided to the Black Star Corp or mercenary group to give to people whenever there was an issue of whose land is this. That's all you have. You basically just have a piece of paper that says get off the land.
Then we're gonna need to contact the union, probably the trade office.
Oh, hell yeah. Good luck getting a response from them in a reasonable time.
How long is the lag time on their communications?
Last time we sent them an order, my uncle was the CEO of this here establishment.
Still haven't gotten back to you then?
No.
Who's someone we can get into contact quickly to...
Why is that my business? I'm running a perfectly legal operation here, and y'all are just coming out here trying to attack us.
We're trying to help you here, because if we can get...
You're trying to help me by killing one of my men. Okay.
Look, what I'm saying is, we're trying to help you for the future. Because if we were sent here and nothing changes, then more people like us will be coming here. We're trying to clear, to make sure that
if we don't clear out this legal situation right now. They might send another team who is less scrupulous.
Oh, I can handle any sort of legal troubles. And she raises her hand and all the guards immediately raise their guns to you. We've had problems in the past and we will have problems in the future. I ain't worried about y'all. I ain't worried about the rest of y'all. Now you can choose what you want to do.
Well, in any case, we'll need to check on our side with our team, essentially our higher-ups. And have them look at this documentation that you're providing for us, because this is obviously changing what we understood from the situation. So it wouldn't make sense for us to considering
what I suspect current... may have happened is the union office in charge of distributing planets such as this and their purchase and trade has lost the records pertaining to this particular planet and ended up selling a new deed to the Steel Lance Refinery. However, your documentation would predate theirs, ergo the property rights would remain yours.
Well, then you figured that out.
If we can confirm that, we'll clear off the planet and not trouble you again.
Then but what are you still doing here? Go on. Figure out your own business. I ain't worried about that.
All right, well, thank you for your cooperation.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for your cooperation. We'll be in touch.
Y'all have a good day now. And she beckons you all out. The guards lower their weapons, but they do continue to escort you out back into kind of the desert terrain. And the guards...
Walk back.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm going to walk back to the shuttle.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're going to need to use the comms to contact the Blacklight.
Black Star,
whatever, whichever one it was, and tell them about this.
Can we reach them from here?
Yeah, no,
should be able to.
Okay.
At least the ship we came from.
Yeah.
All right, let's. Can I leave Merlin? Hey, can I leave you to explain the situation to the Black Star?
Ghost.
What?
I'm staying in our office.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, because you're still hidden and invisible.
You know, it's pretty cool this two-man operation we got going on, because the rest of us are too retarded to do anything. I love it.
So I'm gonna debrief essentially everyone else that's still at the ship and not like in the fucking wildlands over there. But yeah, so I'm just gonna
He should still be able to hear us over local comms.
Oh right. Yeah, so I'll just recap.
You guys are up to date.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Hey, you got Aiden, thoughts in your chat.
Sounds like it's a whole clusterfuck of a situation then.
Aiden, I want you to roll a stealth check.
With advantage or?
Disadvantage.
Okay.
Disadvantage.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, because the building would have proper security systems.
All
yeah, that's right. A
six. Ghost, do you have a mod in your Twitch chat? Because there's bots.
I can hop in. Hang on. Really, there's bots.
Yeah.
I can't do shit, boy.
Imagine having bots.
Wait, why the fuck are there bots?
It'll be the fucking advertisement account.
Yeah, advertising bots.
Yeah.
All right, like, hey, buy bots!
Yeah, we got one FPS, Aiden, Helm.
I'm here.
I mean, Dot and Pass.
Let me know.
Cool.
Alright, Well, Aiden, let's roll another 1d10. Roll a 1d10. Alright. So, you were able to get inside the facility. However, after walking in to what appears to be essentially a armory, mm-hmm. there's an immediate alarm that goes off. The whole base goes into essentially full alert as there's been an intruder detector, an unauthorized stealth suit present.
Ghost?
Hmm?
I walked in with them.
Correct. But you stayed in there.
Yeah, you stayed in after we left, which is why the alarms are going.
But I didn't move around.
Correct. The room.
Yeah, no, it's okay. Yeah, I'll just. Yeah.
The room is equipped for stealth detection.
Okay.
Surely it would have gone off beforehand then.
They were allowing unauthorized guests to begin with.
So this okay.
Disabled.
So the security system was partly
correct.
Disabled.
Correct.
Okay.
God, I hate technology.
So, the entire base is now on full alert.
Is there a panel nearby?
Take a look around.
I
don't suppose we'd be able to hear it from here.
Yeah, no, you see
we hear the alarms going off.
So is combat inevitable at this point?
You hear distinctive, almost like raid siren noises, and you see lights begin to flick on every single area of the base.
In response to your question, even if combat is inevitable, it's probably best to not open fire until they've opened fire on us.
I suppose that'd be our fearless leader over there.
You voted me.
Oh yeah, sounds
saying.
Like it.
All right.
Maybe I'll be in the ship.
you hear your outpost, your station. You hear the ding, 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 as your shuttle is being contacted.
All right, open up comms.
It's one of the guards. They simply state that they are on full alert. If you try to enter the facility while anything goes on, they will treat you as a threat, and you will be handled as such.
Alright, so we just chill on here, then.
He immediately hangs up, and the base begins to kind of skitter around with activity.
What'd I miss?
Aiden fucking triggering the alarm.
Did Aiden do the cloning thing?
I believe so, yeah.
Oh, then we're fine. Let's go.
No big loss there.
Oof.
Right, we need to get in contact with, I think his name was Dom, whoever our commander was.
Mm-hmm.
We need to contact him, assuming comms are in range.
Oh yeah, no, you're still in channel.
Alright. Merlin, do you want to explain, or do you want me to explain?
You can go ahead.
Alright. Basically, the short of it is,
hang on, what do you want? It's 3 in the damn morning. Jesus, why aren't you calling Katie for this?
The short of it is, Steel Lance may or
shut
may
up.
Not actually
shut up.
Have...
Shut up. Oh, what do you want?
You know Katie's here, right?
Alright, we'll just contact Katie instead.
Good. He hangs up immediately.
Alright, bring up Katie instead.
Hi, pilot, how you doing?
Alright, can you check purchase logs for planets for this planet?
Hang on. Yes. Okay, it is currently owned by the Steel Lance Refinery Company. What's wrong?
When did they purchase it?
It looks like during the third grand project.
Who did they purchase it from?
The Union.
Do you have the full purchase history?
Yes.
Alright. We have been presented with a document from George and Company. That seems to be a deed to this planet from the duration of the first grand project.
Mm-hmm.
Legally, does that supersede the Steel Lance's third project deed?
No.
Why not?
They have the most recent proof of history. The first grand project was millennia ago. To be honest with you, there aren't really many records or even proof that the first grand project was successful. So most of that has been essentially scrubbed out of the data records to make way for the second and then eventually third or current grand project.
I upload our copy of the Georgia Company's deed to Katie.
Okay.
We have been presented with a physical copy of this deed. Does it appear legitimate?
Well, it appears legitimate, but that doesn't mean they have any proof of access. Now, I believe Pilot, the mission was to remove anyone and all persons onside the planet.
We are attempting to do this as peacefully as possible.
Mm-hmm.
If we can prove one way or another legally that that they may or may not have access to this planet, we may be able to convince them to leave peacefully. At least that's the idea.
That's a great idea, Pilot, but that's well above my pay grade. You figure it out.
Yes, because the AI, I'm sure, gets paid.
So, from the Union's legal perspective,
mm-hmm.
All deeds from the first expansion project are null?
That is correct.
Alright.
That's very likely why, if there was a purchase made in the second and or third, it would be recognized.
But a purchase made in the first is not.
Pilot, that was a long time ago.
Yes, okay. But...
Can you forward us the exact Union rule set that defines this?
Mm-hmm. Sure thing.
Alright.
Anything else, Pilot?
I do not need anything else from you at this time. Thank you, Katie.
Okay, have a great day. She hangs up.
Of course she does. Alright, let's call Jordan.
Oh boy. We're gonna need a bigger army.
Alright.
She picks up immediately.
Alright.
Ghost, real quick.
Hmm?
You said I'm in the armory, right?
You're within Katie's office. So it's the armory / office, hence why there's such heavy security measures to protect the original document.
All right.
So they are aware of your presence, however, they're not for certain whether you're in the armory or anywhere else. However, there are guards coming to protect Katie. George.
Okay.
Yes, protect Katie, our AI overlord.
So, Hector, what's calling?
Yeah, well, that's right. I keep fucking forgetting I've got my own AI as well.
Alright. You said George picked up almost immediately? Alright.
Hang
on. Dog?
Huh?
Hot Mike.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, no, dog's heading out, so I'm taking over the...